And we welcome you all to Lewis Field in Stillwater, Oklahoma. And we welcome those of you that have been watching the Florida-Tennessee football game. We're a little late getting here, so we can wait for the completion of that one. It's the Aggies taking on the Cowboys of Oklahoma State out here in Big 12 country. Now, let me show you what you've missed. One touchdown so far in this game by Oklahoma State. And David Thompson leaped over the line. This is after an 11-play drive that was aided by a very big personal foul call against the Aggies. So that's the point where we're at now, as the Oklahoma State Cowboys lead at 7-0. From the Aggie standpoint, they've had a little trouble rushing the ball with Abu Wilson. We'll talk about that in a moment. And they've also had a big turnover right near midfield. Abu Wilson fumbled, and the Cowboys took the ball from there. They didn't actually score on that turnover. But that's what's happened to this point. Dave Fox along with David James. And again, we welcome you to our broadcast. And it has been kind of slow going for Abu Wilson so far, but Thompson's looked great for the Cowboys.
David Thompson ran for 252 yards in Oklahoma State's win over Tulsa last week. Right now, 8 carries, 41 yards, and a touchdown.
And we're underway now with the Cowboys' third possession. And that's Thompson again. You can see why this guy is such a great running back. And he follows a long line of them here, as we mentioned. Of course, we mentioned it, but we weren't on the air at the time. Some of the other great running backs.
Barry Sanders went here. Ernest Anderson went here. Thurman Thomas is from here. So, yeah, they've had a few guys here who can run the ball. And Thompson's doing it today. And what we've seen so far in the first quarter is they've basically been running behind the left side of their line. That 11-play, 80-yard touchdown drive that is game's only points right now, 7-0 Oklahoma State. Basically, they ran it behind the left side of their line. They've thrown just 2 passes, completed them both for 22 yards.
That's the big fullback, Brian Akins. He'll do a little bit of the work. The bulk of it, of course, will be David Thompson, 28. But occasionally, they'll give it to Akins, number 45, and he gets enough there for the first down. There is 2 minutes to go here in the first quarter, and the Cowboys leading 7-0.
That is just Akins' second carry of the day. 2 carries, 6 yards. Thompson, in the first 3 games of the year, and Oklahoma State is 2-1 right now. In the first 3 games, Thompson carries the ball in about 40% of their plays. David Thompson is the man, and they've been in the eye most of the game, although they break out of it here and have 3 receivers to the near side.
Pass is complete to the big tight end. Spencer Wagner is on the coverage, but Alonzo Mays, 265-pounder. He is the leading receiver, just to let you know how much they like to use the tight end. 7 receptions so far coming into this game, 107 yards.
They do not throw the ball a lot. They've not thrown the ball a lot here in the first quarter, but Jones is now 3 of 3 for 36 yards. Not a lot of throwing, but very effective.
And they've got a first down here at the 41. Cowboys leading by a touchdown, and they're on the drive. Jones will give to Thompson, and he'll try the right side this time. Gets around the corner, and he's got a lot of room. Thompson all the way down to the 21. And that really boosts the old yards per carry, which is already more than you want it to be in this game.
He ran for more than 1,500 yards last year, and he is devastating today. Now 10 carries for 87 yards. They've been running left all day. Mostly he's been running between the tackles, and here he pops it outside, and he shows he's not just a power back. He's got speed, too. 38 yards on the carry.
All the way down to the 21. First and 10 for the Cowboys there. This time it's Andre Richardson trying the left side. And look at this. Still on his feet.
He is very close to another first down.
Richardson, the other running back in the backfield, along with David Thompson. They're both pretty close to the same size.
And once again, you can see the defensive line has moved downfield. The Aggie defense has had a real problem. The defensive line has not been holding the line of scrimmage. Not only have there been some nice holes, but the guys have been getting pushed off the line a couple yards. They got to stand their ground. Now, the interesting thing is when Oklahoma State got down here on their touchdown drive, they almost didn't score. That was third down when he dove in. The Aggie D played pretty well in the red zone.
Second and one. Richardson. And he will be caught behind the line of scrimmage. And that's the first time we've seen a play fail on the left side for Oklahoma State.
The Aggie defense looked good. This is Oklahoma State's third possession of the game. In the first possession, Oklahoma State went three and out. The Aggie defense looked good, but as the quarter winds down, Oklahoma State is ready to score again.
That's the end of quarter number one. Cowboys 7, Aggies 0.
Utah State football is brought to you by Middlecoff Lincoln Mercury, by Chuck-O-Rama, by Arby's, by your local Ford dealer, by Icon Health and Fitness, first in fitness, and by Blue Cross and Blue Shield.
You've been looking and waiting for the best buy on the right vehicle. Your patience just paid off. 96 early closeout at Middlecoff Lincoln Mercury. Save up to $4,000 off invoice. Invoices posted on every 96 car and truck. Remember, the invoice price posted is the price Middlecoff paid for the vehicle. The 97s are here, and every 96 must go. Save up to $10,000. 96 early closeout only at Middlecoff Lincoln Mercury.
The choice is yours at Chuck-O-Rama. Come on down home to the family place. Bring along your friendly face. Grab a plate or two. It's just like going home. So much to try, nothing's hard to find. So it moves on everybody's mind. Head on down, there ain't no need to roam. The choice is yours at Chuck-O-Rama.
Having your car stolen can be a real blow. You work hard for these things. That's why Farmers Insurance is all about getting things back to the way they once were. From the way policies are written to the way claims are handled, everything we do is about getting you back behind the wheel. It's what we think auto insurance should be about. Let's face it, if somebody really wants your car, they're going to get it. But with Farmers, we can at least help get you back where you belong.
Here's Coach John L. Smith looking on as he needs his Aggies to make a defensive stand right here. It's third down and three. Cowboys already up by a touchdown. Here we go. David Thompson gets a nice block by the fullback. There's a flag in the backfield. Thompson has the first down, but let's wait and see what happens to the flag on the flag. And Alonzo Mays, the tight end, is kind of looking around like he got caught with his hand in the cookie jar, and he did. Holding.
They are going to back Oklahoma State up. And the one thing that the Aggie coaches said before the game they really wanted to do is they wanted Oklahoma State in passing situations. No question. Listen to Bob Simmons interviewed on the radio here the last couple of days. He says, we have got to stay out of long down and distance situations.
Holding, offense, a 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul, repeat third down.
Well, that definitely puts them in a passing situation. You'll notice, you remember at the beginning of the season, they were actually telling you the number of the guy that committed the infraction. They don't do that anymore. After a few weeks, too many complaints, the NCAA told them to knock it off.
And there was a hold right there. Now it's out of the screen. But that is going to bring up third and from it's from the spot of the foul, so it won't be third and 13. It's going to be third and about 11. But this is the first time Oklahoma State's really been in this. Well, they had a third and 7, I guess, in the opening possession and didn't convert that.
Tony Jones, the quarterback, number 9, looking to throw. It's a draw. Jones has a lot of room.
It's going to depend on the spot. He needed to get right to the 11, and I think he's going to have it.
I think so.
I think he got just inside the 11. He's just dropping back and looking to see if there's any split in the lanes, any hole, and yes, there is. He gets a good block. And that move right there got the first down. He knew where he had to go, and he was just lunging for it. They are going to bring the chains out and measure it, but it looks like the nose of the ball is inside the 11.
Those of you that watched the BYU game today saw Donald Sellers do that all afternoon in a heck of a ball game between New Mexico and the Cougars, which BYU eventually won by just 3. And he does have the first down by the length of a football. There's a big play there for Oklahoma State, and now they're in position to score again, already leading 7-0. David Thompson back into the game at running back, and you would figure that And you've got a first and 10 at the 11-yard line. It's going to be on the ground.
They've already got 17 carries for 113 yards, and we're early in the second quarter.
Thompson tries the left side. Cuts back, and what a cutback touchdown. Cowboys.
Actually, the Aggies get good penetration right there. When you make a back loop back, a lot of times that'll help someone come up and make a play. But a great cutback by Thompson. Man, talk about vision. Most guys, once they get outside, they're just going to head for the corner. But he broke it back inside and got his second touchdown.
And with the extra point, Oklahoma State has now moved on top 14 to nothing. Aggies need to get something going when we come back.
Fred, how many people you think live on this planet?
I don't have any idea. Why?
I think half of them are across the street at the Ford dealer.
Ford's factory authorized clearance is here. Get great savings on every car and truck in stock. Like a 96 Ranger now with 1,000 cash back. And that's on regular cabs and super cabs, 4x2s and 4x4s.
Yow.
That's 1,000 cash back on every 96 Ranger right now. Ford's factory authorized clearance has got the competition worried. But it won't last forever. So see your local Ford dealer during Ford's factory authorized clearance.
Kimball Roofing, confidence you need in Salt Lake, Ogden, and Provo. Our experts will inspect the roof of your home or business and help you choose the best solution for leaks, weather damage, and aging. Have Kimball Roofing repair existing vents and roofing surfaces or replace your roof with highest quality materials, including durable asphalt shingles, tile, wood, all metal systems, or the latest flat roof membranes. All of our work is guaranteed, and we offer maintenance programs that can double the life of your roof. Protect your lifetime investment with the quality work of Kimball Roofing in Salt Lake, Ogden, and Provo.
The secret's out. Have you heard? Everybody's spreading the word.
The secret's out. The taste of Arby's new chicken, bacon, and Swiss puts ordinary chicken sandwiches to shame. It starts with Arby's marinated and seasoned whole breast filet, our special recipe, so it's extra tender and juicy. Plus our own thick-cut peppered bacon and rich honey mustard.
The secret's out.
You can't beat Arby's new chicken, bacon, and Swiss. Try it and taste why it's better out here.
Well, this is not the start the Aggies wanted, especially when you're playing a team that loves to run the ball, because Oklahoma State will be content to just sit back and run it all afternoon. There's Bob Simmons, head coach here. Comes out of that Neil McCarthy group.
McCartney. Neil McCarthy. That's the former Weber State basketball coach. Bill McCartney.
Bill McCartney.
He was part of...
We went through that on the radio show the other day. I kept calling him Neil McCarthy.
It was part of that. They really turned the program around at Colorado. Colorado was at the bottom of the Big Eight, really struggling, and he was with them as that program grew and became first a contender in the conference, then a champion, and now he's moved on here after he helped win their national championship, and now he's moved on here. He's in his second year at Oklahoma State. They won four of their last six games. First time the Cowboys have won four out of six games. Granted, they've done over two seasons. First time the Cowboys have won four out of six games in the 90s.
And they are hoping he could do the same thing that was done at Colorado here. That ball is bobbled, but they'll down it. On the other side of the ball, Coach John L. Smith, of course, comes out of that Dennis Erickson coaching group.
The excitement of the Nike Utah Classic continues. Announcing a very special sale on the cars driven by the players and officials. Get $1,000 cash off Park Avenue, America's best overall car value. $1,000 cash off the sizzling Regal. Sanctuary, take $1,500 cash off. There's up to $3,000 cash off on all 96 models and spectacular savings on the 97 Tournament LeSabres. Hurry into your Mountain West Buick dealer.
For 55 years, we've been with you wherever you go. No matter how far from Utah you've ventured, you've been covered. You don't put limits on where you can go in life. We don't limit your health care choices. For health insurance, the best solutions, come out of the blue.
Hey, Antoine, have you seen the new equipment at Upper Limit?
No, Hot Rod. Let's check it out.
Finally, a well-built, pulled-up treadmill. It's new from Spirit and Upper Limit. Equipped with a stronger frame and more powerful motor, the space-saving Spirit leaves the competition flat. And with its exclusive self-lock-in feature, Spirit outpaces the pack on safety. Try the new fold-up Spirit treadmill at Upper Limit.
Upper Limit, Utah's largest fitness store.
Well, the big dog shop.
In Salt Lake and Orem.
Aggies with the football, first and 10, as they try to get something going here in the second quarter, trailing by 14 points. Matt Sock got the start, and he has gone all the way for the Aggies so far in this game. Quick pass outside, it is complete, and that should be and is enough for a first down. Aaron Frazier on the reception. The leading receiver coming into this game doesn't have a reception yet.
No, but Sock's done a nice job moving the ball around. He's now,
actually, he does. Jenkins has one.
Yeah, Jenkins has one. He's actually now throwing passes to four different receivers, and Sock is starting off 5 of 8 for 103 yards here early in the second quarter. And it was interesting in the papers here, they were talking about how well the team's coming out of the West, the Big West, the WAC. They all throw the ball, and Oklahoma State secondary really going to be tested. And now that the Cowboys have an early lead, you can bet the Aggies are going to be putting it in the air.
Reverse coming. Matt Sock leading the block. And great yardage for Steve Smith. Smith all the way down to the 35, and the trick play worked for John L. Smith. Boy, they needed something to get him going. Steve Smith with great yardage.
Smith picks up 35 yards. He's doing it all. He's been a great receiver for the Aggies this year. He's a junior college quarterback. He can do it all. He's also had some success in high school returning punts and kicks. Very little he can't do. Oklahoma State's had great pursuit, maybe a little too much pursuit, a little over-pursuing here, and boom, he turns the corner. Nice little block right there by Sock, and a great cutback, 35 yards for Smith.
Back to live action, a quick pass to the outside is caught by Nakia Jenkins, his second reception. And Steve Smith, by the way, one of four players who are contributing. John L. Smith got out of Chaffee College, so he has some sort of pipeline out of that school.
This is exactly what the Aggies need. Start moving down the field, get a couple of big plays. One guy they've thrown to a couple times, a couple of ad-lib plays, big tight end Guillermo Chavez. He has a couple catches for 61 yards.
He had a beauty in the first half that was tipped to him by an Oklahoma State defender, Wilson now. And again, that running game is just stopped by Oklahoma State. He gets 2 yards at best.
That is 7 carries for 11 yards for Abu Wilson. Now, Oklahoma State's run defense, they've really had problems in the first three games. Every feature back they've faced has run for at least 130 yards. They have stopped no one. This is the best run D they have played. This is the best quarter in quarter and 2 minutes now of run defense. They really struggled. Texas Tech had a back eat them up for 272 yards a couple weeks ago. Of course, the Aggies see Texas Tech next week.
Second and 8. Quarterback draw. Sock is caught.
Quarterback draw. On the
receiver,
number 17, Matt Sock.
Bob Simmons was criticizing his Cowboys, saying we're not disciplined enough. There's too much freelancing. But that's nice discipline there. A good call by the Aggie coaching staff, because Oklahoma State has had a good pass rush today. So you run a quarterback draw, maybe catch guys freelancing, not staying in their lanes. But they were. They were right in their lanes and took Sock right down at the line of scrimmage. Actually, looks like they're going to mark him back with a 1 yard loss.
Third down. And they're calling it 9 yards. A big third down play. Matt Sock has 4 wide receivers. Cowboys showing blitz. Dumps the ball off. A nice catch is made, but it's going to be just short as Sean Turner will be brought down at the 14-yard line. Or 16-yard line. He needed to get to the 14-yard line. And I don't see the field goal team coming in yet.
Well, it's going to be fourth and about...
Two.
A great thing about the Aggies, in third and three or less this year, they are tremendous. 7 of 8 times they've converted on third or three or less. Here they got to pick up 2 yards on a fourth down. The one time they didn't convert was against Northridge after the game was already decided and they had the reserves in. The starters have never been shut down in a short yardage situation.
And right there, Oklahoma State appears to have jumped off sides. The center, of course, snapped it as soon as he saw him make contact. So good play by Brandon Dyson. And is that the case? That is the case. Matt Stock signaling that we just got the first down. Now they're in the red zone, and as you well know, the Aggies have been dynamite in the red zone this year.
And Bob Simmons is chewing a kid out now, saying lack of discipline. He was talking about this in the week leading up to the game, and boom, lack of discipline right there. On fourth and two, you jump offside and give him a first down at the 11-yard line. Three penalties for 25 yards now on Oklahoma State, two for 20 on Utah State. The interesting thing is the freshman, Brown, was in the back. It wasn't Abu Wilson there. It was one back, and it was Brown, the freshman.
Aggies are 12 of 13 scoring when they're inside the red zone. And there is Brown. Brown cuts back to the right. Touchdown, Aggies.
Give the number 21,
DeMario Brown, a youngster, a true freshman from California. John L. Smith just loves this kid. He told us this week he's got to be able to keep him in the ballgame for the Aggies to succeed. And right there, Brown pays dividends.
Clutch drive. This stadium was rocking. It was 14-0. The Cowboys have not blown out anyone this year. The two games they've won, they won them both in the fourth quarter. This place was rocking, and that was a great drive by the Aggies. This crowd has gotten very quiet. Yep. The Aggies are back in it.
Point after is good, and as you say, the Aggies climb right back into this. They had to have a score there, and they got it.
Accident victims tell why they chose Siegfried & Jensen.
I'm Stan Sumrell, and a few years ago, I was involved in a very serious head-on collision that all but cost me my life. And so I called Ned Siegfried of Siegfried & Jensen. I wanted a firm that would take care of the paperwork and dealing with the insurance companies. They cared and they worked hard for me. And I can recommend Siegfried & Jensen to anybody.
Call Siegfried & Jensen at 266-0999.
The new Giant Caesar makes everything else look small.
What are you looking at?
The Grand Canyon.
Where?
Right there.
Where?
Right there.
What you eating?
Giant Caesar.
What you stepping in?
Has to be China.
Everything looks small next to the Giant Caesar.
What?
The Giant Caesar. Giant slices with giant pepperoni. $9.99 carried out or have it delivered.
Pizza, pizza.
I take pride in the reputation that our dealerships have. I guess it comes from starting a business in a small town where everybody is on a first-name basis. That's the way we still want it to be. If we can't make buying a new car or truck an enjoyable experience, then we're missing the boat.
Willie Deal?
You bet he will.
Willie Ford, Willie Honda, Bountiful.
This might sound a little strange, but Trent and John and Jason make it fun to buy a car just like it used to be.
Clutch drive by the Utah State Aggies to put the football in the end zone and trail now 14-7. That was a big drive. Aggies needed to score, and they did. And the key to that drive, of course, the one big play on the reverse that worked to perfection.
Great time, and the Oklahoma State defense have been playing well. They were fired up. They were playing hard, and the Aggies thinking, hey, it's 14-0. Great call by the Aggie coaches. Maybe they're going to be a little too hyped up, and they caught him over pursuing 35-yard gain. You know, the other big play, the penalty on fourth and two.
Huge penalty. Yeah, that was huge. Offside that gave him that first down. Or Oklahoma State had gone five quarters without allowing a touchdown until that one.
They beat Tulsa, their in-state rival, 30-9 last week, gave up three field goals. That was a 13-6 game in the fourth quarter, and then Oklahoma State wore Tulsa down, pulled away with a 17-3 advantage in scoring in the fourth quarter.
Kick's going to be short, and it will be returned. But not much. Now they'll get it up to about the 20-yard line. So Oklahoma State comes back out there. There's some pushing and shoving.
And mixing it up down there.
R.W. McQuarters, he's a good one.
McQuarters, he's not only a return man, a safety on defense, he played on their basketball team last year. This guy can do it all. And yesterday at practice here at the stadium, the Aggies, when they punt, they are working on kicking knuckleballs, kicking to the sideline away from him, no high floaters. They do not want to give him a chance to return. I guess he would be the, he's the die of the Big 12. He's the return man you do not want to give the ball to.
Well, and Utah State had a kid last year who played on the basketball team. Thompson. And this time they wrap him up around the right side. But remember, his success has been coming on the left side.
On the stop with Utah State number 10. They'll
give him 2 yards there, so pick up of 2, second down and 8. And you really want to stuff that run on the first play. You don't want to give him a second 3 or something like that.
And officially now in his 12th carry, they've got him for 99 yards and two touchdowns. Is he something else?
David Thompson. Coming off a 250-yard-plus game last week. Second down and eight. Aggies jump this time. Right there at the nose tackle. Of course, the Aggies don't have a nose tackle. But the lineman, Aaron Mitchell, jumped up. And remember, Mitchell's the guy.
Offside defense. Still second down.
It's come into the game because of the injury to Walter Fiafia. We saw him have to leave the game earlier. And now Mitchell will come off the playing field and no doubt have a discussion with coach. Well, that helps out. And now they're right back to where you didn't want them to be. Oklahoma State with a second down and three. They'll give to the fullback. And another fullback. You know, they just keep them coming.
The carry for the Cowboys out across the 30.
Kevin Brown.
Cowboys. First down.
With the carry there. So that's now four running backs that have carried for Oklahoma State. Of course, David Thompson, the premier running back. They've got Andre Richardson back there, and then Brian Akins, the big fullback.
So
first down already, once again, for the Cowboys.
We've seen Thompson leave the game, take a quick breather. He's back in now. He's a deep back in the eye. But he's going to get his 30 carries. He had more than 30 carries last week against Tulsa.
Jones to throw. Quick pass to the outside, and nobody's covering the tight end. And they finally run him out of bounds at the 45-yard line. But that's Alonzo Mays, who had a big catch in their first scoring drive. And he's a big kid, 6'6", 265-pounder, the leading receiver coming into the game.
Little play-action fake, and the way Thompson's been running, those are going to be effective. They do not throw a lot, but they're throwing very effectively today. Mays now has two catches for 28 yards. Jones is 4 of 4 for 50 yards through the air. Oklahoma State really starting to put the passing game together a little bit, and they have had some problems there.
Yeah, you would figure you want him to have to throw, but not having much trouble right now. They'll take the left side, and there's a hole once again. And that left side has really worked for Oklahoma State. The Aggies have got to close that up.
I would say going back to his passing, Dave, the key is he hasn't had to throw. He's been able to throw when he wants to. They haven't been caught in bad down and distance situations. And so he's been able to throw off the play action fake, really pick a spot.
On the stop, number 7, Mike Pedersen.
And let's take a look at the Ford power run and that powerful running back, David Thompson, who has just eaten up the Aggies today, especially going around that left side, piles up some more right there.
And look at the hole. He's going through there untouched. He's not having to break even an arm tackle. There's anybody bouncing off him. He's got the full head of steam breaking through the line of scrimmage.
Second down and just two is what they need. So they will throw. Ooh, and that was a rocket that was well in front of Sean Love. Yeah, Tony Jones put a little too much on that. That'll bring up a third down and a yard and a half. But for Oklahoma State, a yard and a half, that's a little trip at the line of scrimmage. The way they've been running today, no problem. Opportunity here for the Aggies to really tighten up on defense and hold them. In the backfield. They need just under 2 yards. And Thompson's got it.
Give me number 25, Andre Richardson.
Oklahoma State moves into the Aggie side of the football field. First and 10.
The sun has finally gone down here. We have beautiful weather. You notice the whole field's in shade here. And now Oklahoma State, when they do have to throw, and he's got the first, look at him just driving through those legs, about 5'9", 200 pounds. But now, looking downfield, the Oklahoma State was driving into the sun. Aggies in the first quarter looking into a fierce sun here, beautiful weather.
Brutal.
But the brutal low sun was really the only negative here on the field early in the game. And now we're completely in shade, so that's no longer a factor.
Well, you know, the interesting thing about this stadium is that most stadiums, at least like the ones in Utah, are on north-south stadiums so that the sun doesn't really play. Here, it's an east-west stadium.
Exactly.
And so for any game that starts, imagine if this game started at 5 o'clock local time, you'd have 2 hours dealing with it.
Well, the Aggies shutting down that left side finally. Boy, the Oklahoma State line, the left side has been so effective, but the Aggies starting to stomp them there.
Well, they held him to a yard on that one, so a second down and nine. Second down, a crucial play here. Jones looking to throw and complete again. So another big pickup, and once again, they'll be left with third and short. I think the longest third down, did they have a third and seven once?
Mm-hmm. Well, they had the third and 11 they converted That's on their last drive with a quarterback draw.
But we've seen third and two and third and three all evening.
You know, it's hard to believe. We've heard so, I mean, we've only been in town 24 hours. We've heard so much criticism of Jones as a quarterback. He got pulled in their season opening win over Southwest Missouri. They went to the backup, who was a freshman. Backup came in and rallied him. They were actually behind in the fourth quarter, rallied, forced overtime with the freshman quarterback. This isn't the guy we've been hearing about the last 24 hours. Jones
is good tonight. Second down, he needs two. Third down, he needs two here. And he's going to keep it again. And Jones gets the first down. So once again, when the Oklahoma State only needs a couple, they convert.
On the ball of the Utah State 31, game good for a Cowboy. First down.
He's just looking, picking a hole, and there's a good one for him.
Just grind it out. That's all they want to do here in Stillwater, Oklahoma, is give the ball to the backfield or let Jones keep it and just pound you, use up the clock, pile up the yardage, and that's what they've been doing. First and 10 at the 31-yard line. Oklahoma State leads 14-7. And right at the line of scrimmage, Andre Richardson.
Well, the Aggies starting to play a little better on first down. The down and distance, first down is just such a crucial down. We looked at the Aggie offense over the last three games, and when they averaged 5 yards a carry on first down against Utah, they won the game. When they averaged 8 yards a carry on first down against Northridge, they blew them out.
Yeah.
But when they only averaged 2 yards a carry on first down last week against Southern Miss, they lost. Now, looking at Oklahoma State here, they've been running the ball very well on first down until this drive. Now, they managed to keep it alive, but second and long enough times and the Aggies are going to stop.
Jones looking to throw. There's a flag down in the backfield. And I'm not sure what they're going to be because there didn't seem to be anybody near Danilo Robinson.
That's an incomplete pass. He was juggling it when he went out of bounds.
It's holding anyway.
It's holding back at the line of scrimmage. Watch on this replay. In the corners of this field, they lowered this field a few years ago, brought the stands closer to the action, but there's no room to that. It's almost arena football.
Especially when the band is standing.
Yeah, when the band is there.
There's nowhere to go.
He is juggling. You can see right there, the ball is loose. That's a good call. It wasn't complete. Not that it matters with the hold anyway, but he goes smacking into that wall. There is only 5 to 7 yards, and off the back corner of the end zone, there's even less than that. Those walls are practically in play.
Fortunately, they have very thick padding on them.
Yeah, tell that to the guy who smacks into
it. Yeah, right. There he is.
He's limping a little bit.
Terrence Richardson, his brother is the other running back.
A 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Repeat, second down.
So that'll be a big penalty because the spot of the foul was about 6-7 yards deep into the backfield. That'll push him all the way back to the 42-yard line, leaving him with a second down and 21. And that's a little better.
But it's just hard to believe how much they controlled first down. The Cowboys have had great down and distance. Second and 21. Here's a chance for the Aggies to shut them down and get the ball back with a chance to tie it up.
You would expect Jones to throw here, and he will. And very good coverage. You know, there wasn't a single receiver beyond the 40, well, maybe the 39-yard line, which is 3 yards past the line of scrimmage. Not one. There's John L. Smith giving the official some instruction.
There's no question Jones has a strong arm. He really drills the ball in there. These guys are only 5 or 7 yards downfield.
They're backing off.
Yeah, but you know, that's a great thing for the Aggies on a pattern like that, because thrown that hard, it could get tipped up, and then anything can happen, you get the turnover.
Third down and 21. You don't want to do anything here, anything crazy that would give up a cheap one.
Remember, when they had third and 11 on their last drive, they went to the quarterback draw, and it worked.
Jones. Here he goes. Oh, he's got a block. He's got a lot of room. And Jones is going to get the first down. Well, dangerous, dangerous quarterback.
That was not a draw. That was a scramble, but it had the same effect. It was third and forever, and he made a big play. Third and 11. He picked up 11. Now it's third and 21, and you can see he gets a crack. He gets outside, and that is it.
That is a crusher.
Now, there is a flag. Yeah, there is a flag across the far side of the field. The ball came to the near sideline on the 30 on the far side of the field, a flag.
They're all pointing at the Aggies, though.
Yep.
Well, that doesn't help. This is going to be a huge pickup when it's all said and done. Remember, they started back at the 42.
Holding defense. The penalty is declined. First down.
So they'll decline that and take the 22-yard pickup. Wow. First and 10 at the 20-yard line. Cowboys looking to score again. And they've really chewed up some time as well.
Yeah, this drive's over 6 minutes old now.
Jones in trouble. Gets away. And then fires another rocket.
His receiver fell down after he threw the ball. Nothing he could do about that. Alonzo Mays was open when he made the break, and then he stumbled going towards the sideline.
So the Aggies almost had it there. Jeremy Hunt Loveless was bearing down. Boy, Alonzo Mays, he is a load to have to cover.
Well, they got away with that, but those linebackers and the defensive ends, when they're back, they're going to have to contain this guy. He's made too many plays. You cannot let him get outside the pocket and start improvising, because so far, everything he's tried
has worked.
He's converted a third and 11 and a third and 21. He can do no wrong right now.
Second down, 10. Back to the running game in the backfield, and Thompson got a lot of room down to the 4, and there's going to be a late hit. Dwayne Nelson, the young man that took him out of bounds. And here comes another penalty. Oh, John L. Smith can't be happy right now.
You've got to stay home, because he has proven he can cut. The play was supposed to go up the middle. Never mind. He bounces out to the left. We have seen him make a couple unbelievable cuts. He made a great one on his second touchdown run.
Wow. Down.
Incidental felt face mask on the defense. We'll go half the distance from the end of the run. First down.
So they're all the way down to the 2.5-yard line. And keep in mind, just a few moments ago, they were at the 42 with a second down and 21.
See, we can see the face mask. There it would be right there. Incidental. 4 penalties for 27 yards now on the Aggies.
First and goal. Kevin Brown and Thompson in the backfield. Thompson. No. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage.
Who came up and filled that hole? That was a good
hit. Looks
like
John Dale Carty as they unpile. Yep, yep. That's the case.
John Dale
good
Carty.
Good move, Mike.
Nice play. Because once again, you could see him bursting up there looking for where to cut. And the first man has rarely brought Thompson down. And right here, he's picking the hole. There it is. And then, boom, it's gone.
Good tackle by Carty. Second down, no gain there. And goal.
And no receivers, 3 tight ends.
Thompson again. Oh, flipped over. He will not make it. It'll be about a yard short, but he dove and then got nailed.
That's how he got his first touchdown, going up top, but he got hit and spun around big time.
Take a look at an icon defensive play and watch the hit.
Gonna get hit in the leg. That's what's gonna start in. Whoa.
Woo.
And the feet get to the goal line, but it's where the ball is that matters. And the ball is still not quite to the 1 yard line. Maybe about 3.5-4 feet to go here. Third and goal.
All right, big third down coming.
I wonder if this is 4 down territory or if they'd settle for the 3 if they get stopped here.
Boy, all the way down here with this running game. Well, we'll have to see in the backfield. It is Thompson. Thompson takes it. Touchdown. Well, David Thompson scores again, and it's that left side. They are really attacking that side of the Aggie defensive line.
Unofficially, 18 carries, 134 yards, 3 touchdowns. He's already had a great game. He is something else.
after is good, so the Aggies down by 14 once again, and they'll have 3:51 to work with here in this first half. And just as what, you know how long they've had the football, they used a lot of the clock, but as was the case last time the Aggies got the ball, they've got to make something happen and score. We'll be back.
The last thing this planet needs is another goofy gadget taking up valuable space.
Yeah.
Must be my Proform invented the Space Saver Crosswalk. They don't call it Space Saver for nothing. Get it? Then get it.
Ford dealer's been offering deals like $600 cash back on Contour during factory authorized clearance. It's left the competition with a lot of extra time in their hands.
Yes, sir.
For $600 cash back on Contour plus savings on every Ford in stock, get the factory authorized clearance at your local Ford dealer today.
Yes, my point.
Your point. You hit it off the windshield.
You can hit it off the windshield.
No, you can't hit it off the windshield.
Get the factory authorized clearance at your local Ford dealer today.
Welcome back to Stillwater. Oklahoma State scores again, and it's David Thompson. What a night it's been for that young man as the Aggies now fall behind 21-7. 3:50 to work with in this first half. They've got to get something going, and it's Abu Wilson near the goal line. And Wilson fumbled the ball. That's his second fumble. He's actually dropped three. But two fumbles credited to Abu Wilson, and there's another one, and that is a huge, I mean, that is a game-breaking mistake right there with 3:45. And we'll be back to see how the Cowboys respond to that.
The choice is yours at Chuck-O-Rama. Come on down home to the family place. Bring along your friendly face. Grab a plate or two. It's just like going home. So much to try, nothing's hard to find. So when food's on everybody's mind, head on down, there ain't no need to roam. The choice is yours at Chuck-O-Rama.
The Mercury Challenge is on at your Mercury dealer.
Your Lincoln Mercury dealers have been challenged to clear all their 96 models. That means 2,300 Mercuries must be sold before September 30th.
Who knows how much you'll save?
Get great deals on every 96 Mercury. Prices start at just $11,570 for Mercury Tracer after $600 cashback. And there are savings of up to $1,500 on Mercury Villager.
Don't miss the Mercury Challenge at your Mercury dealer now.
See Ken Garf, Bountiful Motors, or Middlecoff Lincoln Mercury today.
Well, let's show you what happened here as disaster strikes for the Aggies. Abu Wilson has the football. There's a penalty being announced right now. We'll explain that one to you because that's the only break in this whole thing. Right there, he's stripped. So Oklahoma State gets the ball, but then they celebrate too much. Excessive celebration pushes them all the way back to the 38-yard line.
It'll be first and 10 at the 38 with 3:45 to go. Now, Oklahoma State has not been scoring quickly. That last drive, 16 plays, 80 yards, 7 minutes and 10 seconds.
And they could easily use up the rest of the half if they wanted to. We'll see what happens. Tony Jones, the quarterback. David Thompson behind him. That's Richardson behind him. And Richardson tries the right side, and he's good for about a yard and a half. We'll give him 2 yards on that. And the clock will continue to run. Costly mistake for the Aggies right there. They needed to not only hang on to the ball, but they really needed to score before they went into halftime. And now you've given Oklahoma State an opportunity. And if you go into halftime down 21 points, that's painful.
You know, the defense has been playing better here, although the score doesn't reflect it right now, that they put Oklahoma State in some difficult situations, but they've never made the big play and sealed the deal. They've let them turn a third and 11 into a first down, turn a third and 21. into a first down. And now, as Oklahoma State burns a timeout, it is second and eight. The Aggies got to make the two plays and seal the deal here.
Second down's been tough for them. Well, Oklahoma State's going to take time out to talk about this. We'll do the same. Aggies come back with 3 minutes to go here in the first half, looking for a big defensive stand.
The secret's out. Have you heard? Everybody's spreading the word.
The secret's out. The taste of Arby's new chicken, bacon, and Swiss puts ordinary chicken sandwiches to shame. It starts with Arby's marinated and seasoned whole breast filet, our special recipe, so it's extra tender and juicy. Plus our own thick-cut peppered bacon and rich honey mustard.
The secret's out.
You can't beat Arby's new chicken, bacon, and Swiss. Try it and taste why it's better out here.
The excitement of the Nike Utah Classic continues. Announcing a very special sale on the cars driven by the players and officials. Get $1,000 cash off Park Avenue, America's best overall car value. $1,000 cash off the sizzling Regal. Sanctuary, take $1,500 cash off. There's up to $3,000 cash off on all 96 models and spectacular savings on the 97 Tournament LeSabres. Hurry into your Mountain West Buick dealer.
Second down and 8 yards to go. Oklahoma State has the ball. You see the time remaining in the half and a 21-7 lead for the Cowboys. And on the left side this time, Spencer Wagner is right there to stop the play. Nice move by Wagner.
Boy, there was a hole there, and he just threw the blocker away and plugged the hole. That was a nice play. Third and seven now for Oklahoma State, and Utah State has just, and they've got to make a play. You cannot let people off the hook like this again and again and again. It was a nice play by Wagner, though. He just shed the blocker, stepped in, and made the sure tackle.
You notice the back of their jerseys, they don't write their names on them. It's not like it's any sort of an athletic department expense they can't afford. John L. Smith wants it that way because he believes in a team game rather than individuals. So either home or away, they have their names on the jersey. Big reception. There's a flag down right in the middle of the pile, so this is probably coming back. But a reception made at the 20-yard line by Willie Grissom.
We had a takedown back at the line of scrimmage. Let's see if we'll be able to see it here. I think it was the left guard who made the takedown, and they were about to convert a third and seven again, and now it'll be third and 17.
Illegal block in the back. Now, once again, you've got
illegal block in the back on the offense. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Repeat third down.
Got to take advantage of this situation. Remember, there was a third and 21, and Tony Jones got free.
Well, this could easily be a 7-all game because the Aggies on the Cowboys' second touchdown drive let the Cowboys convert a third and 11. On the third touchdown drive, let them convert a third and 21. And I'm sure what John L. Smith is going to say at halftime is, guys, we are two plays away from being in a tie.
Well, and
game.
Don't forget the fumble in the very first drive. The Aggies at midfield, they don't give that away. Who knows what happens? Third and a bunch. They need 21 yards. Jones rolling out. Here he goes. He's got a lot of room. And he's just short, but man, he almost made that. 2 yards short of the first down, and that just goes to show you how dangerous that quarterback can be. You know, you always wonder if he's just dropping back there with fully intending to run that ball eventually.
It's hard to believe how much grief this guy has taken in the first month of the season. He got pulled in the season opener, replaced by a freshman, and on the Chuck-a-rama second look, he's trying to convert another impossible situation. Aggies have got to stay home, stay in their lanes. This guy is unbelievable. And you've got, he's going to be tough enough to contain, but you can't give him any breaks. And that time, he had the whole left side of the field to work with. You've got to stay in your lanes and contain him. I mean,
they're going to have a fourth down and two, and it looks like Bob Simmons and his coaching staff, they're over there discussing whether or not they want to go for it. Right now, they have not sent the punt team out.
Well, they don't punt it. It's either a field goal or they go for it. Yeah. It would be a 47-yarder. Their kicker, even though he's just a freshman, he made a 63-yard field goal in high school. It's the longest kick in Oklahoma State history. It is the fourth longest kick in prep history in the USA.
Oh, no, and we got a penalty.
And there's no decision to make.
From the end of the run.
Oh, man.
Holding a 10-yard penalty
from
the end of the run.
What a costly mistake.
So they did let them out of a third and 17. And he's saying, why is it from the end of the run? Why isn't it take the penalty or the play? And you could read his lips right there. He was saying, why is it from the end of the run?
Another back breaker. They had a third and 21 before they scored the last touchdown. Here they have a third and 21.
Third and 17.
Third. Well, they had it at third and 21 here for some reason. But anyway, it was a bunch, and they get it. Incredible.
Let's see if we see the defensive hold. We're probably not going to see it here because it was probably a receiver downfield that was being held. Direct in traffic. Jones has now converted all three of these long third downs by himself. One was a quarterback draw. The last two have been scrambles.
Why would you even have a holding on the defense on a play like that? Everybody's in pursuit.
Well, my guess is it was on a guy. It was probably on a receiver who was out in the pattern.
Will the clock operator please set the game clock to 2 minutes and 13 seconds?
With the game clock, it's going to be 2:23, run down to 2:13. You know, they recovered the fumble at the 22-yard line and moved back with a couple of penalties. Now they've moved forward. It's taken about 10 minutes to play a minute and a half, and they're 2 yards in front of where they recovered the fumble in the first place.
With a first and 10. Oh, man. This is incredible.
And the crowd's in a pretty good mood because they just gave the scoreboard operator a tremendous hand for running 10 seconds off the clock.
Moment.
First down and 10.
All right, first and 10 at the 20-yard line after all that. Mistakes just kill you. Tony Jones on the option. We've seen a lot of this. And they read that one well. Ben Crosland is the last man to finally bring down David Thompson. And Danilo Robinson got there. Danilo's limping a little bit.
Crosland played well on this series, not only making the tackle there, but he was the guy who was held on the takedown earlier in the drive. He was closing in on Jones for a sack when they got the two-point takedown against him.
Second down and 10 now. And the clock continues to run. There's really not going to be much time for the Aggies should they get the ball back. Jones. Throw behind Thompson. That'll stop the clock. 1:28 to go and bring up a third and 10. But they've seen a lot worse than third and 10.
You guys are going to be down here.
Those are the kind of passes that got Jones in trouble earlier in the year. He had a perfect pocket. His line gave him great protection. No Aggies in his face, and he had a guy who had a half step out in the flat. There's no touch on that ball. You need to loft it over to the defender, lead the receiver, let him run under it. Instead, he zinged it behind him for an incompletion. But given what he's done on third down in this first half, I don't think the crowd's too upset with him right now.
Well, he needs to get to the 10-yard line. Now watch him break out of here if he doesn't throw the pass. Incomplete.
Crowd wants pass interference, and they're not getting it.
So the Aggies have finally held. Oh, man. And the field goal team will come out, but I believe the Cowboys punted twice in this first half or just once.
They punted on the opening drive. I think they scored three straight touchdowns now.
So this is one that the Aggies should be thrilled that they're walking away from. Tim Sidness.
This will be a 37-yarder, and he's the guy who kicked a 63-yarder in high school. He's a redshirt freshman.
He missed it. He missed it to the right. So after all that, the biggest thing that cost the Aggies is time.
But the defense gets a little confidence, and they keep it a 14-point game.
Minute 19 left when we come back in the first half.
Mom says dinner's ready.
No time to eat. I'm finally ready. I've got all the latest Canon equipment. Printer, copier, word processor, my own multifunction scanner, copier, fax.
Get the guaranteed low price on over 7,000 items and free delivery. Staples, we've got that.
Aggies get the ball with only a minute 19 to work with. And, you know, in this, we were just talking, in the second quarter, they've only had the ball once because of the time that Oklahoma State has taken off the clock. And then, of course, the fumble. One time they've had the football. Now we're going to check and see who is being looked at here.
We had to pass along one score while we have a second. Texas Tech is leading Georgia 12-0 in the fourth quarter. And Texas Tech, of course, will play both these teams. The Utah State Aggies go to Texas Tech next week, and Texas Tech is in the Southern Division of the Big 12, so they'll be playing Oklahoma State later this year as well. I think Texas Tech has to come in here to Stillwater.
By the way, that's John Dale Carty. And this isn't anything the Aggies need right now. We hope Cardi's okay, but he is a big part of that defense. Second leading tackler behind the linebacker, David Gill. Good thing is he's at least moving around, but he appears to be in some pain there. Oklahoma State crew coming out to help, and now they're bringing out a stretcher. So obviously they're concerned enough that they want to immobilize him. But as I say, he is moving.
Now, if John Dale Carty, if they follow the depth chart with him gone, the guy who's going to come in to replace him is Matt Wells.
The Cube.
The former quarterback, and guess where he's from?
Let me think. Salisaw, Oklahoma.
He's got some friends and family here in the crowd. Well, his dad's been following the games everywhere. His dad's flown to Utah to see him play. Dad's been everywhere, but I'm sure he's got a few more friends and family and neighbors who made the trip here.
Well, all you got to do is spot number 14 jersey up in the crowd if you can, and that's Dad. He goes, like you said, he follows him everywhere.
And now his son is going to get some major minutes here.
Now, hopefully, all is okay with John Dale Carty.
We should mention, coming up at halftime here, we're going to go back to our studios. Reese Stein is going to have some sports scores and highlights, including highlights of that BYU game this afternoon. Very competitive, very close game. We had a chance to see that here today.
They got a quarterback similar to this kid, although I think
New Mexico, you're referring to.
New Mexico passes a lot better, at least, you know, what we've seen in the last couple of passes out of Tony Jones. But Donald Sellers, fine little passer and a good runner. And a heck of a ball game against BYU. The Cougars won that 17-14 was the final. Now they'll bring the golf cart out and everything. So definitely he's exercising caution with John Dale Carty here. As I said, he was moving his legs and his arms, but indicated there was a lot of pain.
And unofficially right now, we have David Thompson with 143 yards rushing on 19 carries, 143 yards and 3 touchdowns for Thompson, which sounds like a lot of yardage. It is a lot of yardage, but we should also point out, it's not really a reflection on the Aggie defense. This is what Thompson traditionally does. He had 204 yards in the first half against Tulsa, even against Texas Tech. Very good football team, a team a lot of people think is going to finish second in the Southern Division behind Texas in the Big 12. He had 73 yards on the first half of that game. So he has had some enormous halves, and I guess we had him at 19 for 134. They got him officially at 20 carries and 129 yards here. Tremendous half. 3 touchdowns for Thompson. All 3 of Oklahoma State's touchdowns.
Well, they're still on the field trying to help out to get John Dale Carty onto the cart. And we'll certainly keep an eye on this situation and update you. I didn't even see where the hit. No. But, of course, it would have been on that field goal attempt.
Well, if we get some information in the second half on how he's doing, we'll certainly pass it along. A lot of times these things are precautionary. I mean, you remember earlier in the year, the game most people probably saw, they saw Emmett Smith going down in the Monday night game.
And they carried him out.
And that was a tense situation, and it turned out okay. So hopefully it's just a precautionary thing with him.
Well, you can see, as I mentioned, Carty is moving around, and he's talking to the folks there. And they'll lift him up now and put him on the cart.
Still a rough moment for players on both teams, because everybody knows these kind of things can happen in the game. I mean, it's a pretty violent game, and you try not to think about it too much, but it's tough when it's your teammate right there.
What is it John L. Smith said about football a couple of weeks ago? It's not figure skating. And everybody's getting hit on every play. But again, he is moving. And a nice hand from the Cowboy crowd. Well, we'll keep an eye on the situation and let you know as soon as we hear. But again, I want to stress that John Del Carty was moving and was talking to the folks there. And you would assume that this is precautionary.
When play resumes here, there's going to be a minute and 19 seconds left in the half. It'll be interesting to see how aggressive the Aggies are here. They're backed up in their own end of the field. It'll be first and 10 at their own 20. It'll be interesting to see if they really go after it. They have been throwing the ball with some success. Now, they haven't been on the field because Oklahoma State had a long touchdown drive, and then the Aggies fumbled the kickoff return, and then Oklahoma State had the ball for another large chunk of time before they missed the field goal. But in their last possession, the Aggies scored a touchdown, and for the day, Sauk, who has faced some pressure from the Oklahoma defensive line, Sauk has got good numbers. He is 7 of 10 for 112 yards. So he's got some good numbers.
Well, like I said,
I don't know if they want to risk a turnover this deep in their own end zone. So
they haven't had the football. It's amazing. They have one drive in the second quarter. He's under pressure now. Sauk wide open at the 35-yard line, across the 40, and good yardage picked up by Sean Turner. The ball will be spotted at the 43-yard line. So the Aggies are making the move. That stops the clock with 1:08, but it'll start right back up again.
Well, they've got to stop it while they move the chains. That was the first down, 43-yard pickup. Now, the Aggies have all of their timeouts. Both teams have all of their timeouts. So the Aggies have three timeouts, four within the final minute of the half.
Sauk again, going down the sideline, has a receiver, and it's intercepted. He had, or at least he was looking at Nakia Jenkins, slightly underthrown. And R.W. McWhorter comes all the way over and intercepts the ball. Oh, boy, you hate to see that if you're the Aggies.
That is Utah State's third turnover. First interception to go with a couple fumbles.
The icon defensive play. Here it comes. R.W. McWhorter leaps. Well, he came just from the center field position, and Matt Sauk obviously didn't even see him. The ball, if Jenkins... it's the only guy you're looking at. It's a well-thrown ball. Well, now Oklahoma State has 58 seconds. You would assume they're going to run the ball. And again.
Pass from Jones, incomplete. Intended on the left side.
Tony Jones' first pass, incomplete. Willie so dribble. That will stop the clock with 53 seconds to go.
Second down, 10.
Jones now 5 of 11 for 57 yards. He's done most of his damage in passing situations by taking off.
Yeah, by running. He's twice converted third and very long.
And a third time with the help of a penalty. Boy, if he's going to throw the ball, though, the Aggies got to see if they can make a turnover.
Draw. Here he goes again. And Jones will get all the way up. That pick up 8 yards.
Across the 35.
Clock will continue to run.
Third down and 3 for the Cowboys.
7 carries, 64 yards now for Jones unofficially. Not bad for your quarterback.
Yeah. And this time they'll go back to the ground game, and presumably, well, if the Aggies hold him here, he may as well stop the
Aggies,
clock, and they're calling a timeout.
They want a timeout. They want to see if they can make the Cowboys convert this and pick up the first down. They're going to be a little short here. It's going to be third and about a yard. And you can see the advantage here, because if they stop him here on fourth down, then you got a chance to go after a punt block, maybe get a bad snap. No reason to let the Cowboys off the hook and let them jog in the locker room. If you can, one hideous play for the Cowboys right now, one quick touchdown. And is that fourth down now?
Yes.
They didn't change the marker. Now they changed the marker.
Yeah.
So they are forcing the punt right here. It looks like it's going to be fourth down and about half a yard.
Aggies hoping they can get a little punt return or
a
maybe
block.
A block.
I think John L. Smith is
put everyone on the line.
John L. Smith's going to be standing on the sidelines right now, and here's what he's going to be saying. Snap it over his head. Snap it over his head.
And you never know. Every once in a while, you say one of those things. You got to. It's the smart percentage play by the coaches. Make the Cowboys execute, and if they don't, you could pick up one big play and turn this thing around and be right there at the half.
By the way, in the second half when we begin, Oklahoma State will get the football first. The Aggies received the kickoff to start this game.
Happy 50. More than half a yard short. Oh, they're a full yard. Remember that, don't trust the yard markers on the full side. This has turned into a beautiful night here in Oklahoma. This is great.
You can see
football
forever
weather
here. You know that?
Really?
There's no mountains. You can see forever.
Not a single cloud. Great sunset off to the west now. Beautiful night. No wind, hardly. A little breeze maybe, but not much. So Aggies ought to be able to throw the ball in the second half. No problem.
Well, they're not bringing in the punt team. Bob Simmons is obviously concerned about that snap over the head as well.
Well, yeah, but if they don't pick up the first down here, the Aggies are going to have a chance to heave the ball into the end zone at the end of the half. Yeah, so they, of course, they may just be trying to draw them offsides here. Remember, the Aggies on their touchdown drive, fourth and two, drew Oklahoma State offsides. And I think the Aggie defensive line better be careful right here because this could be a very long count.
That's what they're doing. And Aggies aren't fighting. He's trying everything he can.
There's delay of game.
They tried.
John L. Smith says that's okay. Great discipline by the D line. And now they're 5 yards closer to the end zone if there's a really bad snap. No problem.
Oh. Well, you got to give Jones credit. I mean, he barked out Hike about 20 times. Now he's never budged. And now we've got an Arby's punt. And it's a good one. All the way back to the 11-yard line. And there won't be any return. And 2 seconds left in the half. I thought the clock was going to run out, but there will be 2 seconds.
That's a change of possession. So even though he's tackled in bounds, on a change of possession, the clock stops, and Utah State will have 2 seconds
to put their knee down
or to heave the ball down the field and try to make some magic happen.
Utah State 13.
You know, the thought of it just scares me to death, you know? He drops back. Oh, he's hit from behind. Oh, fumble. It's scooped up and touchdown. Now, that hasn't happened in... 5 hours since the BYU game. But that's what
they've
they're going to do. They got them all on the
trips
left.
Trips to the left, Dave.
All right, be careful. There we go. All right, so the Aggies get out of there without any more disasters. And they'll go to the locker room and listen to head coach John L. Smith's instructions, trailing by 14 points.
The best buy on the right vehicle. Your patience just paid off. 96 early closeout at Middlecoff Lincoln Mercury. Save up to $4,000 off invoice. Invoices posted on every 96 car and truck. Remember, the invoice price posted is the price Middlecoff paid for the vehicle. The 97s are here and every 96 must go. Save up to $10,000. 96 early closeout only at Middlecoff Lincoln Mercury.
We get many calls to Siegfried and Jensen from accident victims who have problems dealing with insurance companies. Each case is personally reviewed by Mitch or me and handled by a lawyer who heads a team of experts to get you the best recovery possible.
At Siegfried and Jensen, we not only care about each and every client, we have the experience to go up against even the biggest insurance companies and win.
Siegfried and Jensen has the experience you need if you've been injured in an auto accident. Call today, 266-0999.
impossible to forget.
I'm gonna have to pull the trigger.
I like that girl.
Impossible to resist.
You've never done that before.
And impossible to survive.
What are you gonna do?
I'm going to get our money. On September 27th.
She's one hell of an athlete.
A bombshell will hit the valley.
This is a nice place to live. I would like to keep it that way.
Really?
2 days in the valley. Rated R. Starts September 27th. For 55 years, we've been with you wherever you go. No matter how far from Utah you've ventured, you've been covered. You don't put limits on where you can go in life. We don't limit your health care choices. For health insurance, the best solutions come out of the blue.
From Channel 2 in Salt Lake City, this is 2 News Special Edition.
Good evening and welcome to our special halftime edition of 2 News.
Topping our news today, 4 people are dead, all members of the same family, in an apartment fire in Ogden. The fire broke out just after 11 this morning at the Clay Apartments. When firefighters arrived, heavy flames and smoke were pouring out of the second and third floors of the building.
I've seen all kinds of people run out. And then I've seen all kinds of people jump out the windows and stuff, and I heard windows busting out, and that's all.
A big flash of black smoke hit me in my face at that particular point in time. I shut the door, I laid down flat on the floor, and I started to yell help out the window.
Police and firefighters were able to pull out 8 people from the windows. One woman who was pregnant dropped from a 4th-story window to escape. No word yet on the cause of this terrible fire, but firefighters say the building is a total loss. The Red Cross is providing food and shelter for the displaced tenants.
After months of suspicious activity, West Valley City Police issued a search warrant to break up a methamphetamine lab. The lab was being run out of this house. A SWAT team surrounded the house early this morning and arrested 6 people who were in the process of manufacturing drugs when police arrived. A baby found in the house was turned over to other family members. Officials suspect large quantities of drugs were being produced, but they won't know exactly how much until later.
Until we can get search teams in that can actually search the place. We do have a search warrant, but as of yet, we're just pretty much containing the place until the lab can be shut down and dismantled, and then our search can take place.
As we mentioned, 6 suspects are in custody, but police believe there are several more people involved. They continue their search for them.
One of the best-known people in Utah is sharply criticizing Utah's congressional delegation in the wake of our new national monument. At his Sundance resort today, Robert Redford cast the delegation's actions as undignified, whiny, and vindictive over wilderness and the monument.
And it's not going to be at the expense of mining. It's not going to be at the expense of jobs. And I think the facts will prove that if people just give the facts a chance to be known and stop listening to the delegates whining and this sort of narrow-minded, vindictive behavior that's coming out of from them.
But more in our interview with Robert Redford coming up tonight on 2 News at 10.
Can't have woods without trees. That was the message today as staff and clients gathered to plant trees to celebrate the opening of Valley Woods Mental Health Apartment Complex in West Valley City. Public and private donations allowed the facility to buy 100 trees to help landscape the new complex. Among the volunteers were residents themselves who donated their time and money toward their new home. Valley Woods offers the mentally ill affordable housing with support services. The director of Valley Woods says having housing for the mentally ill helps them gain independence by learning daily living skills.
This is their opportunity to become part of the community, to really blend in and normalize their lives. And with the help of staff and other clients, they can do that.
Some of the donations from today's event will go toward construction of another facility. Eventually, 224 units will be available. And across town, there was another celebration going on, the annual Avenue Street Fair. This year's fair was held at the intersection of First Avenue and J Street. There was a little something for everyone. Fishing for the kids, booths with different wares for sale, lots of great food, and lively entertainment. The street fair is a way for neighbors to get better acquainted and a way to raise money for the Avenue's Community Council.
It's been a great success. We have had a lot of people turn out, and we've had a good time, and hopefully we'll do the same next year.
The Greater Avenue's Community Council meets once a month to discuss issues that affect the neighborhood, like traffic, new developments, and also housing prices.
We're all doing it for the third day in a row. We've got Macarena on 2 News.
And you sing it well, so go ahead,
Greg. We're not going to sing any Macarena. You know, they had great weather today, and it was a pretty nice day to get out and do just about anything. A great day to maybe get out and hit the links. Well, if you didn't get a chance to do it today, how about tomorrow? I'll let you know what the forecast is right after this. Stay tuned.
There's no typical person that falls behind in their bills. It happens to anyone in any occupation. And for a lot of reasons, it happens to people just like you.
Well, they announced a no more overtime policy. I thought I could manage. But then they cut back even more. I can't keep up much longer.
Falling behind on bills can happen to anyone. Get back on track without bankruptcy. Call Consumer Credit Counseling Service. Don't wait.
For cars that can benefit from higher octane...
Frank, we're late.
Texaco Clean System 3 Power Plus and Power Premium are formulated to clean your engine's intake valves, fuel injectors, and combustion chambers while you're driving. For smooth starts and sure acceleration, just give us 5 tanks, and we think you'll see a difference. A word of advice, though. Maybe you'd better leave the windows rolled up.
Add more life to your car! Take it to the star!
Now that's what I call a perfect 10. My 10 games include not only the Rockets, but the Bulls.
Oh, Michael Jordan, oh yeah.
Now look at B's, Spurs and Lakers.
Yeah, yeah, I want to see Shaq in a Lakers uniform, man.
B's the one, the Sonics and the Knicks.
Oh yeah, there's nothing like B in there.
I picked Plan D.
Weekend Plan! I love basketball.
For a perfect 10, call 355-DUNK.
They run up the scores whack. BYU scoring fewer than 20 points against New Mexico. That hasn't happened since the Ford administration. Highlights of the Cougar game in Provo coming up next.
The failure for the Aggies and the success of the Oklahoma State Cowboys and turnovers.
Three turnovers for the Aggies, none for Oklahoma State right now. And it's a key third down conversions, really, for Oklahoma State to keep their last two touchdown drives alive. I'm sure in the locker room tonight, the Aggies are saying, listen, two big defensive plays, this would be a totally different game. Play that. We're not really getting hammered as badly as it looks.
Let's show you some of the highlights from this first half. And it's all Thompson in terms of scoring and yardage. And of course, Tony Jones helped out. Take a look at this. This is the first one.
David Thompson going up high for the first of his three touchdowns. He's run for 131 yards in the first half. He had 252 last week against Tulsa. He's again another great game. This is a pretty touchdown run. This is the second one. Second quarter makes it 14-0 Cowboys. Great cutback. Great vision. Following the footsteps of Barry Sanders and Ernest Anderson and Thurman Thomas.
O.J. Anderson.
The Aggies got back in it with a great touchdown drive. Down 14-0. They drive the length of the field to Mario Brown. Only carry of the game.
Yeah, it's the only time we've seen him.
One carry, 11 yards, and a touchdown. The Aggies have had problems running the ball here in the first half, but DeMario Brown with a nice run there to get him back in the game.
And then Tony Jones has twice did this. He drops back to pass and then breaks containment. Look at this.
He hasn't scored a touchdown, but he set up those last two, breaking containment, turning a third and 11 into a first down here, turning a third and 21 into a first down with a 22-yard scramble. That's it up. The third touchdown, this makes it 21-7. Thompson gets his third score. Of course, later on, the Aggies fumbled, and the Aggie defense came up big on the last two possessions, and so it's still 21-7 here at the half.
Let's take a look at the Middlecoff Lincoln Mercury halftime statistics. And one of the categories that really hurts is way down near the bottom, those three turnovers. But look at the rushing yards as well.
227 to 45. Oklahoma State outgaining Utah State. And remember, 45 rushing yards, but 35 of them came Smith on the reverse.
That's right.
He was a big part of that. So there's 100 yards in difference in total offense. Look at the time of possession, 21 minutes for Oklahoma State. They've been grinding it out. Utah State with 8 minutes and 44 seconds.
And really, in that second quarter, the Aggies had one sustained drive, and that was really about it. Not rosy in the first half, and those three turnovers costly. Oklahoma State didn't actually score off of any of those three turnovers, but the Aggies' drives were, you know, of course, interrupted. There's Bob Simmons trying to get his team off to a good start.
He is turning it around for Oklahoma State. They're trying to win for the fifth time in seven games. They have not done that since the 80s. And their 21-point win over Tulsa last year was their most decisive win, their biggest margin of victory since the 1988 Holiday Bowl. 62-14 over Wyoming. Barry Sanders ran wild.
Barry Sanders was in, yep.
Bob Simmons, he's got a very good chance to be a hero here in Stillwater. He's got him going in the right division. And Oklahoma State, it'll be interesting to see what they do in the Southern Division of the Big 12, but they could get as high as maybe third place.
Well, the Aggies got the kick to start the game, and unfortunately, we weren't able to show you the first couple of drives because we were still with the Florida-Tennessee game, but they were moving until they fumbled the ball at midfield, and this kickoff brought to you by Arby's as we are set to get underway in the second half. Aggies will give up the ball first and test their defense right off the bat.
Good kick.
Kick fielded near the goal line and getting out of one tackle. It's still on his feet. It's McWhorters. And a great return close to midfield. McWhorters all the way to the 47-yard line. And that's not the way you want to start the second half.
He is so dangerous. They wanted to kick away from him, both in the punt and the kick game. They did not want to give him a chance to break one, and we saw why right there. That was a pretty high kick. It carried down to the goal line. But he breaks a tackle at about the 20-yard line and gets him out close to midfield. High kick. He's waiting for it. Right here, the Aggies are still in good shape, and boom, he runs through that hit at the 16-yard line. And you miss a tackle on him, and 30 yards later, you finally get him out of bounds. McWhorters plays on the basketball team. He's a point guard, plus he's got the football duties here as a return man and a safety.
Tony Jones brings him out, and here they come on the ground once again. There's a flag down. So this play may not mean a thing, but it's David Thompson starting off in the second half. And let's wait for the call.
See if we can see the replay where the penalty is. Might have been a hold inside there.
Yep, against Oklahoma State.
I think it was. We didn't get a good view of it there, but I think that block that sealed off and allowed him to bounce outside. It wasn't exactly a block, maybe.
It was more like a lasso.
Holding offense, 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Repeat, first down.
Yeah. That will make it first down. Let's see, the spot of the foul was 3 yards. Beyond the line of scrimmage? No, it's about first and 20.
It looks like the spot of the foul was right about the line of scrimmage. Yeah. That's 8 penalties for 83 yards now on Oklahoma State.
Jones. Be careful, he's a danger to run. Here he goes, but he's caught from behind this time.
Ball's down, it came loose, but they're saying he was down. You know, the interesting thing there is when he started to tuck the ball away and look for somewhere to go, he checked, he didn't see a lane, he checked again, he didn't see a lane. Aggies contain him this time, and they get the sack. He's come out of the pocket for big gains on third and long this time. Look at right there, where do I go? It was nothing obvious. Everybody in that defensive front line held their spot, did not give them a lane to escape, and they get the sack.
John Latu with the sack. They have come very close.
And that was also a coverage sack. We got to credit the defensive backfield there. He had plenty of time to throw and couldn't get it done.
Second down and 23. Give on the right side to David Thompson. Can't find anywhere to go, and he's cut down by the Aggies after a gain of 2. So that's going to bring up, you hate to even say this, third and 21. And, you know, their conversion percentage on third and 21 is pretty good.
Just because they converted third and 11, third and 17, and third and 21. They've done it the same way. It's just one mistake. You solved that one thing, and we saw him do it 2 plays ago. Get that defensive line, keep the pocket, keep an eye on Jones. Don't give him a lane to escape, and you'll be okay, and you'll get good field position. Don't think about the stuff in the first half. It's behind you. It happened.
All right, I've already forgotten half of what you said they have to remember to do. So imagine what they're going through.
Well, I think they
David
heard about
Gill,
it.
By the way, is stretching at his hamstring there. We'll keep an eye and see what that's all about. They're helping him up now. He's only the leading tackler on this team. If he comes out, I suspect that he'll all get back. It looks like a cramp because he keeps trying to stretch it out. Jeff Lemo will replace David Gill, but as I mentioned, it probably won't last long if David can get back in at all.
I think looks like he's working the right quadricep just above the knee pad there.
Well, it looks like every time he starts to walk, it tightens up on him again.
He's giving those defensive backs and linebackers a good breather out there.
Yeah.
He's a good man.
That's
good read.
The plan.
There you go.
Yeah, they like you pointed out, they haven't had 3rd and 21 since the last time they converted on a third down. Got to keep an eye on Tony Jones. He will drop back the pass, but if he sees a seam, he'll take off.
Jones officially 6 of 12 passing for 58 yards in the first half, so the defensive backs have done a nice job. He's not hurt, keeping to 50%.
Here we go. You need to cross midfield and get all the way down to the 43-yard line for a first. And Jones is sacked this time, and credit Ben Croslin for coming in from behind and wrapping him up. And the defense, I don't know what John L. told him at halftime, but they have come out fired up.
He blew by the left guard at a full sprint. Tremendous move by Croslin.
Let's take a look on this.
He's
going to defense.
Bottom
play.
Of your screen, right there. Ooh, pushes him inside. See you later. Bye-bye. I'm going to get the quarterback. Perfect containment. No chance for Jones to sprint outside.
And that's Davis. He's just a freshman on that line for Bob Simmons. Hunt is away. Hang on to it. And Bandy's got it with some room. Oh, Jason Bandy ran into one Cowboy who could bring him down, and then he's finally dropped it. Nice little return on that punt, so the Aggies will come out and take over. 1st and 10 up at the 42-yard line, which is
good field position.
Their best starting point by far in this game.
They've been backed up most of the night. You mentioned the offensive lineman that Croslin beat for that sack was a freshman. Well, here's the interesting thing. Now, Bob Simmons trying to rebuild this program. 11 freshmen or sophomores start on this Oklahoma State team, a young, inexperienced team.
Young group. Aggie's got the ball, and we'll join them when we come back.
Factory authorized clearance has the competition guessing.
Yes, I was wondering if you're really discounting your Ford as much as it says in the paper. You are.
You're kidding. Save on every car and truck, including Ford Windstar. Now get the minivan with the highest government safety rating and $1,500 cash back. With an offer like this on Ford Windstar, the competition has nothing to do.
Got any threes?
Hurry. Factory authorized clearance is only for a limited time. So see your local Ford dealer today.
Tires aren't always the first thing on your mind. Until you find that pothole out there with your name on it. Trust Uniroyal Tires with DuraShield construction built for puncture resistance, long tread life, and durability. Take the worst the road can dish out and still keep you going. Uniroyal Tires. Driving dependability home.
Visit your local American Car Care Center today. Check the yellow pages for the dealer near you.
Welcome back to Stillwater. The Aggies trying to make a little bit of a move here as they hold Oklahoma State. And now Utah State comes out 1st and 10 at the 42-yard line. Matt Sock with no one behind him. Four wide receivers. Quick pass over the middle, and it's caught. And there's a lot of room for Sean Turner all the way down inside the 35-yard line. Now the Aggies come out with a nice defensive stand and a good play on offense to start things going. And by the way, DeMario Brown now trotting into the game. He's on the ball.
He just came walking off the line of scrimmage wide open. It doesn't get much easier. There's nobody around him. That is easy. Sock hits him, and that's a 22-yard gain. And now you're putting the pressure on Oklahoma State. And the thing we're talking about before the break, 11 freshmen and sophomores. Put a little pressure on them. They're young. They're inexperienced. Get in the game. Give them a chance to make a mistake.
DeMario Brown into the game for the Aggies, and he picks up good yardage. Looks like a gain of six for the youngster. He's a freshman as well for John L. Smith's team, a true freshman from Ridgecrest, California, and he is all business, according to the coach, in practice and in games. Young man that is definitely devoted to this game.
It'll be interesting to see. Abu Wilson had a rough first
Real
half,
rough,
dropping
yeah.
the ball a couple times, once on a kick return, once on a play at midfield that was whistled dead. Interesting to see when they get back to him. Brown scored on his only carry in the first
That's
half.
That's right.
11-yard touchdown run. Picked up 5 on first down.
this couldn't be the game clock running down, because I looked over and it still had 5 seconds when they blew the whistle.
Dead ball, encroachment, offense, 5-yard penalty.
Oh, boy.
And we talked about this earlier in the game. The first down efficiency is so important for Utah State. They averaged 5 yards a carry on first down against Utah. They won the game. They averaged 8 yards a carry on first down against Northridge. They won easily. Scored a ton of points. I think 57-27. They averaged 2 yards a carry on first down against Southern Mississippi last week. They lost the game. They had a 5-yard carry on first down. They had a second and five, good down and distance, and now they back themselves up a little bit.
Second and 10. Sock going to the air. Passes downfield in the hands of Steve Smith, a pass he should have caught but wasn't able to, and he was right at the first down. So you're going to have a third and 10, and there is a player down for Oklahoma State back at the line of scrimmage, one of their linemen. And he's climbing up. It's Jay Grossfield, young man from Texas. He's a senior, but they go freshman, sophomore, senior across that three-man front on defense.
And his replacement, if he leaves now, will be Kerry Lanier, a sophomore. So this team getting even younger out on the field right now. Although the other thing is, Bob Simmons has recruited young guys who can play.
That's true. That helps. Well, the same thing goes, though, for John L. Smith. He's already turned over. We talked about this with the Utah game, about 70% of his team in a year. He's had to use a lot of JCs, which he doesn't like to do, but he needs to do that while he's building the program. He'd like to eventually get where he only brings in maybe 4 or 5 JCs a year, and he says that'll take him about 4 years to accomplish that. But huge turnaround for John L. Smith already.
Well, the thing is, both these guys have won before. I mean, at Idaho, he had a tremendous record getting to the postseason.
Yep, 5 in 6 years anyway, and 3 straight top 20s.
And Simmons was on the staff at Colorado when they turned that program around. So they both got
to
get it done.
To throw, it's DeMario Brown, and he's got a lot of work to do. He's not going to get, he's lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage. So a third down play, they didn't go as deep as he wanted.
On the top of the Cowboys, 22 Brendan Peters.
There's a couple of linemen way back at the 50-yard line, deep on the Utah State sideline, but the officials get them out of there okay before any.
Oklahoma State read that well. A lot of bodies over there, everybody pursuing. There was just nowhere for him to go. Just best, instead of dancing around, just dive forward, get the yard or two you can. And
51-yard field goal attempt coming. Wow, from Micah North. And he has missed 2 from 49 this year.
But he's hit some 50-yarders in past seasons. He can do this.
Got the distance. No.
It was long enough, but it was wide right. And he's a left-footed kicker, and off the right hash, that's the toughest angle. He pretty much kicked it straight down the hash marks.
Well, the Aggies showed some flashes on that last drive, but they come up empty when they really needed some points. We'll be back.
The excitement of the Nike Utah Classic continues. Announcing a very special sale on the cars driven by the players and officials. Get $1,000 cash off Park Avenue, America's best overall car value. $1,000 cash off the sizzling Regal. Sanctuary, take $1,500 cash off. There's up to $3,000 cash off on all 96 models and spectacular savings on the 97 Tournament LeSabres. Hurry into your Mountain West Buick dealer.
For cars that can benefit from higher octane, Texaco Clean System 3 Power Plus and Power Premium are formulated to clean your engine's intake valves, fuel injectors, and combustion chambers while you're driving, to give you smooth starts and sure acceleration. Just give us 5 tanks, and we think Power Plus and Power Premium will make quite an impression on you.
Add more life to your car! Take it to the store!
21-7, Utah State, after a nice defensive stand, gets the ball back, moves it quite a bit. Very costly drop throw by Nakia Jenkins, who appeared to have enough distance for a first down, couldn't hang on to the football. So now the Aggies end up having to give it back. And here comes Oklahoma State after the missed field goal, leading 21-7. And Tony Jones, the quarterback, David Thompson behind him. And Jones looking to throw. Pass is complete. And that should be enough for a first down.
They give you so many looks. We've seen them in triple tight ends. We've seen them in trips. This time they go double tight ends, one back. And play action here to the left side where they've been very successful running the ball. And now when he sprints out, just wide open. Great field of vision. Nobody in his way. Wide open man on a comeback route. Throw it to the first down marker. Textbook stuff. And you got to respect that play action. I mean, they're running behind the left side of that line. They've done so much over there tonight.
Willie Grissom with that reception, first and 10. Thompson. Look at him break out of the tackle. Big flag thrown into the pile. Back near the line of scrimmage.
Early in the game in their touchdown drives, Oklahoma State, especially in that first touchdown drive, they had no problem, but penalties have been putting them in terrible down and distance situations the last couple drives. Remember, Aggies held them the last two drives of the first half, got them a quick three and out with the help of a penalty on the first drive here in the third quarter.
And there's another one here. Holding.
Hold. Offense. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Repeat. First down.
Nine penalties, 93 yards on Oklahoma State now.
Should bring up a first and about 17. 16.
First down, 16 for the Cowboys.
And that is the case. Tony Jones at quarterback. He's gone all the way tonight and done a nice job of leading this team. On the counter. Hand off to Richardson. And Andre Richardson cuts back, and he gets back to the original line of scrimmage.
Now,
and there's going to be a late flag here. There were a couple of players there that were kind of jostled a little bit with each other.
See if we can see it here. I think it's well after the play's whistled dead. Nice hole, but
it's clearly away from this.
Yeah, I thought I saw an Aggie get thrown to the ground, and it may.
Jeremy Hunt.
I think
Loveless.
He did.
Dead ball, personal foul, offense. Dead ball, personal foul, defense. The penalty's offset. Second down.
So that is a do-over. Not really a do-over. Second down at 17.
Highly technical.
Minus, what did he pick up on there? It's going to be, got back to the line of scrimmage, so we'll have a second and 10 for Oklahoma State. 9:17 to go here in the third quarter. Cowboys leading 21-7. Richardson in the backfield as David Thompson gets a breather. And it will be Richardson. Gets a hole on the right side and picks up good yardage, giving 7 yards, which will bring up a third and 3.
You know, he's behind an awfully good running back, but Richardson has great numbers tonight. That is 8 carries for 44 yards. And look at it, just boom, he's got a good hole, spins away from the first guy, gets hit by the second guy, but keeps the legs going, finishes falling forward for another yard or two. 8 carries for 44 yards in a reserve role.
Kind of reminds you of the old, Barry Sanders and Thurman Thomas would have played 1 year together, if I'm not mistaken here. Third down, they need 3. He'll keep it. Tony Jones, stiff arm. Busts him down to the 37-yard line, and another first down. And boy, every time they need something big, Jones seems to be the man that steps up. He's still down on the sideline, though. He's over near the kicking net. They're rubbing that leg there.
See if he twisted it or if he cramped up when he went down. He's looking. Nobody takes him. Turns up field. Good hole. Untouched the line of scrimmage. Straight arm. Little stiff arm. And he's pulling up a little bit there. I didn't see him turn anything. It may be a cramp.
Well, Chris Chalupka will come in then. He's a freshman from Texas, and he has played some this year.
He came in late in the fourth quarter against Southwest Missouri when they were behind. He rallied them in the fourth quarter. They tied the game up and then won it in overtime in their season opener, and he played well. And then he also
there
got some mop-up time against Texas Tech late in the game when they were way behind. So he's got a little bit of experience. And he helped win the home opener here. So he'll take a quick few snaps and get in there.
Would like to thank the following for their support of the OSU Wagon Wheel Program.
Meanwhile, Jones still down on the far sideline and really working that left lower leg.
Owen Thomas Ford and Wilson Chevrolet.
9 carries, 63 yards, and a couple of them on long third downs.
Be sure to ask about the free and discounted services available.
Well, Cowboys fans tonight are definitely getting a glimpse of their future with 11 freshmen or sophomores in the starting lineup. Now the last couple injuries we've seen here in the third quarter have brought young guys into the field of play as well. And these are all guys who are going to be here for a couple years. And now they're in the Southern Division of the Big 12. So they're in here with Texas, Texas Tech, Texas A&M, Baylor, Oklahoma, and Oklahoma State. Oklahoma's down a little bit. They may be on par with Baylor. Texas A&M beat North Texas, a new Big West school tonight. I think it was 55-0. So Texas
A&M, they're thrilled to finally get...
After losing to BYU in Southwest Louisiana, they were a little tense. But you got to wonder, maybe Texas A&M is a team Oklahoma State can play with. And clearly, Texas is the class of the Southern Division right now. Despite the loss to Notre Dame, easily a winnable game. They're up 24-17. Threw a late interception, gave up a field goal at the final gun, and lost to the Irish 27-24 this afternoon. Texas is number one, and Texas Tech looks like the number two team, but then it's not clear. And Oklahoma State, who's been down lately, Bob Simmons in his second year, could be climbing in the Southern Division, could get up to fourth, maybe to third if things break right.
Aggie's getting a glimpse of the future as well, because Oklahoma State comes to Logan next year. This is
and Bob
home
Simmons
and home series.
On our radio interview with him this week,
he wasn't happy about that.
His exact quote is, "I'm going to find out who scheduled that, and I'm going to fire him." Then he left.
First and 10. They'll go right up the pipe. And Kevin Brown all the way down to the 11-yard line. And on your Ford power run, take another look at Kevin Brown.
Let's see, we got a good look right over his shoulder. How big is the hole? That is a nice hole. And then he cuts it back. Another kid out of Oklahoma football. There's so many kids coming out of here.
And another freshman. And by the way, Tony Jones is back into the game. So he only missed the one. First and 10 at the 11-yard line. Oklahoma State threatening to score again. Richardson. Able to score, and then on the other side, Oklahoma State comes right back, and now they're about to open up a 21-point lead.
You know, and he's done a lot of nice things tonight, but you got to credit his blockers there. He was untouched on the 11-yard touchdown run. The guys up front doing the job for the Cowboys.
Kick is up, and the kick is good.
28-7. Cowboys all over the Aggies here tonight.
Utah State 7.
Secret's out. The taste of Arby's new chicken bacon and Swiss puts ordinary chicken sandwiches to shame. It starts with Arby's marinated and seasoned whole breast filet, our special recipe, so it's extra tender and juicy. Plus our own thick cut peppered bacon and rich honey mustard.
The secret's out.
You can't beat Arby's new chicken bacon and Swiss. Try it and taste why it's better out here.
This is the latest video game we're developing, and this is our inspiration, my Volkswagen Jetta. $2.19 a month, excellent. When you write code for 15 hours straight, you gotta get out. The Jetta's a real German road car with plenty of room for four carbon-based life forms. It's got dual airbags, daytime running lights, and side impact door beams. Because in real life, there is no reset button. On the road of life, there are passengers, and there are drivers.
Mom says dinner's ready.
No time to eat. I'm finally ready. I've got all the latest Canon equipment. Printer, copier, word processor, my own multifunction scanner, copier, fax. Nothing can stop me now!
Staples has Canon business machines and over 7,000 supplies at the guaranteed low price. Staples, yeah, we've got that.
There's the young guns cheering on their Cowboys. Oklahoma State looking good. A program similar to the Aggies that's on the rise and the rebuild with a second-year coach. John L. Smith, of course, comes out of that Dennis Erickson group. Erickson struggling, shall we say, with Seattle. He and John L., still good friends. They talk weekly. And the Arby's kickoff is away. And they'll let this one bounce, and the Aggies will come out once again at the 20-yard line, first and 10, but they're trailing by 21 points, and they have certainly had their opportunities tonight.
Well, they got in a hole once before, and things looked like they were slipping away, and they came up with a big, long touchdown drive, and now exact same circumstance. They've got to go down the field here. Sauk has been throwing the ball pretty well tonight, had pretty good numbers at the half. 8 of 12 for 143 yards. The biggest problem is the Utah State offense hasn't had a lot of snaps. The Cowboys have really controlled the ball and the time of possession.
Ooh, there's a flag. Yeah. Definitely got there too soon. By the way, we might also make a note that Abu Wilson has not been in the backfield since that last fumble. He was, you know, receiving there to take the kickoff, but he hasn't been in the backfield since that last fumble. Flags all over the place as Aaron Frazier hit before the ball got there.
Well, Abu Wilson has fumbled three times tonight. One of them was ruled not a fumble, but on the replay, it clearly was, and had a problem holding on to the ball, turned it over at midfield, and then turned it over back at the 20-yard line.
Pass interference, defense, a first down at the spot of the foul.
And DeMario Brown's looked good on the few carries he's had, but I still suspect you can't go away from Abu Wilson. They're going to come back to him at some point. But if Brown's running well and he's hot right now and Abu's struggling, get Abu out, let him sit for a little while as long as Brown's got the hot hand. But we're going to see Wilson again at some point.
Well, Abu's standing on the sideline with helmet on, jumping up and down, ready to go in when they want him. Sox quick pass to the outside, a little low, but it is handled. And, boy, there's a face mask right there. And that'll be a face mask on Aaron Frazier. That is Nakia Jenkins. So he picks up yardage and then gets his face grab.
You mentioned the throw was a little low. Nice grab down at the knees, and then he takes it to the sideline, picks up 5 yards, and no question about the mask. Look at his head spinning around. Whenever a guy's helmet ends up down around his knees, there's something going on.
5 yards, grasping the face mask penalty against the defense. First down.
So a first down for the Aggies. And Nakia Jenkins, who is the leading receiver coming into this game, 23 receptions, more than double the next nearest receiver. And I asked Coach John L. Smith this week if they're going to him, is he just the open guy or what? And he says, well, hey, he's got the best hand. Big kid. That pass was overthrown over the head of Jenkins, but he is, 6'1", 215-pounder, junior college transfer, so he's a good-sized kid.
Sauk now 11 of 17 for 159 yards, one interception, which he threw just before the half.
Which was well played by the center fielder.
And the point guard in the safety.
Second and 10. Four wide receivers for Sauk, and in the backfield, it's still DeMario Brown. Watch out from behind. Let this one fly, and it's just over the head of Nakia Jenkins, and he had to get rid of that ball because the rush was coming down.
But what an arm. I mean, Sauk, big rush. He throws it off his back foot, falling away. I mean, this is less than textbook form, but he overthrows everyone, and it's safe. Look, he's about to get hit. Back foot, falling away, little flick of the wrist. And he overthrows everybody, gets it out there where it's safe. And he's saying, hey, he got held up. I need some help there. He got held up. What an arm. Well, you know, he made the big throw in the Utah game. I still cannot forget that. He was rolling right, and he threw back his body all the way across the field and deep and overthrew the receiver.
Third down. They need 10. Oh, boy. Sauk still looking. Everyone covered.
Late flag back in the middle of the field, and it may be against the Aggies. It's usually where a holding flag is.
back at the 33, but it was thrown long after Sauk had got out by the numbers, out beyond the hash marks. It's actually good hustle by the Aggie offensive line. He gets around, and then that block right there buys him some time. It's a good block. Guy went in low. Way to come in low and avoid that stiff arm.
Yeah, he thought he could get away from that guy. That's why he didn't throw it. He was wrong. Cato comes in to make the
illegal block in the back above the waist on the offense. Penalty is declined. Fourth down.
So the Aggies will have to kick it away, and they really haven't shown much of an ability to stop Oklahoma State. So with 6:56 to go here in the third quarter and trailing 28-7, this is not an ideal situation. R.W. McQuarters standing at the 30-yard line for the Cowboys.
They've practiced punting away from him. You're not going to see a nice, clean, high spiral here. They've been kicking knuckleballs to the sideline away from him that he can't possibly field.
Ooh, almost blocked back. That might have been touched by one of the Oklahoma State defenders, because that ball took off to the left in a hurry. You knew that hurt. It was a miserable shank.
Well, the snap was way to his right, and that threw everything off right at the start.
19-yard punt for Utah State. Stop the ball at the Cowboys 38-yard line. First
and
down.
You can see John L. talking to him about the snap.
But he had some difficulties with the long snaps last week in Southern Mississippi. Had a couple to come to him along the ground. And the key at that point is, no matter how ugly it is, get it out of there. Because even though it's only a 19-yard punt, where he was 15 yards, they picked up 35 yards of field position. He was punting back from the 15 or 20. And you got to get it out of there.
Here come the Cowboys. Tony Jones gives to David Thompson. And again, the defense didn't get much rest there.
The
road doesn't get any easier for Utah State. After here, they have to play at Texas Tech. And then they've got BYU and Logan. Now the officials are going to stop play for David Gill once again. That leg continuing to cramp up.
He's not the only one who has a problem with that tonight. I mean, Jones is back in on this possession, but he went out at the end of the last possession. He's back in at quarterback for the Cowboys.
Now they'll start it back up, and they still are looking at David Gill on the sideline there. We'll keep an eye on him. We still haven't heard anything either on John Dale Cardi in the first half. And he left the game, presumably, to good news is he wasn't moving around and appeared to be okay. More precaution than anything else. Pickup of a couple of yards there for David Thompson. It's going to bring up a third down and 3.
Well, the Aggie defense has to do themselves a favor and get a stop and get off the field here. They were on the field for about 21 and a half minutes in the first half. And the thing about Oklahoma State, the one thing we've seen all through the first 3 games of their season is they like to wear people down and then really put you away in the fourth quarter. We're getting to that part in the game where the fatigue can start to catch up with the defense. They wore Tulsa down last week. It was a 13-6 game. They blew up in the fourth quarter when they wore them down. They wore down Southwest Missouri in the opener and were able to rally in the fourth quarter, catch them, beat them in overtime. And they have run a lot of running plays. They got those big guys just pounding away on you, beating you down, beating you down, beating you down all night long.
And now they just took a timeout. And we'll do the same. We'll be back with the Cowboys leading the Utes by 21 points.
You've been looking and waiting for the best buy on the right vehicle. Your patience just paid off. 96 early closeout at Middlecoff Lincoln Mercury. Save up to $4,000 off invoice. Invoices posted on every 96 car and truck. Remember, the invoice price posted is the price Middlecoff paid for the vehicle. The 97s are here and every 96 must go. Save up to $10,000. 96 early closeout only at Middlecoff Lincoln Mercury.
The choice is yours at Chuck-O-Rama. Come on down home to the family place. Bring along your friendly face. Grab a plate or two. It's just like going home. So much to try, nothing to talk. choice is yours at Choco Rambo.
Evening in Stillwater, and this town is just crazy about their football team. They start the celebration early, like at around noon. They have a little park across the street from the stadium where the kids can come out and participate in some activities. There's David Gill stretching out the hammy. And they love their football team here in Oklahoma. Around the left side comes David Thompson. And another first down. This kid is having a career night.
Well, he's got a ways to go. He had that 250.
No, that's true. He had 252 yards rushing against Tulsa last week, and his line's doing him some serious favors.
I mean,
little penetration into the defensive backfield, turns the corner untouched, doesn't get hit until he's well past the first down marker. How many has he got now? Quick math, please.
By the way, for those of you watching our game, not only is the amazing David James providing color, but he's keeping stats as well.
And it's 24 carries for 150 yards unofficially.
That's amazing. That pass almost hit the wall. And Jones put a little too much heat on that one. We're up second and 10.
Just to keep me honest, in the truck, they're also keeping stats. And, of course, I was just notified I was wrong. It's 26 carries for 150 yards. Anyway, you slice it, he's having an outstanding night. I think the thing about that last pass with Jones is we've seen him sprint out before and be effective, but he sprints out, stops, and sets up. He threw that one on the run. His feet were not set. The ball sailed on him, got away from him, and banged off the wall, which really isn't that bad a throw because the wall's only a couple feet out of bounds. So it wasn't that bad.
Second and 10. With David Thompson in the backfield. And here he comes. And he'll fight for about 3, maybe 4 yards. It looks like they've given him 4.
Gain of 3.
It'll bring up a third down and 7.
You look at his ability to just cut and find the hole anywhere, and he is so strong. He takes that first hit. It spins him around, but he just backs up downfield for a couple more yards.
Aggies need to stop right here.
Third about 6.5.
The pass is incomplete, and good coverage that time by Mike Hudson. It's the first time we've called his name tonight. And he had to defend Alonzo Mays, who's a tough kid to have to cover, the big tight end.
Mays is 6'6", 265, so he was giving up some height and some weight. But the thing is, when he saw Mays start to find, he came up and forced him. Mays came back to the ball. Even if he caught that ball, Mays was a yard short of the first down marker. So nice play by Hudson.
46-yard field goal attempt by Tim Sidness.
Well, distance isn't going to be the problem. But off the left hash, this is a tough spot for a right-footed kicker.
Upright. Wow.
Well, when you're having a good night,
it's 31-7. They do love football out here. You and I had the pleasure of watching a high school football game last night. Let me tell you, there's a lot to do in Stillwater. We drove about 20 miles east and watched Yale High School take on the
Weber Falls.
Here's a replay one more time. Football.
Let's watch him. Man, he's giving a little body English. Come on, come on. Bounce it through. Yo, man, he is. Yeah, okay, got it. Yeah, Oklahoma 8-man high school football last night. It was a heck of a shootout. And this game's 31-7. That game was 44-38 at the half.
And what did it finish? 68-38, I believe.
68-38 was the fall. The final. Yale Bulldogs warmed down in the second half.
Well, the team, Weber Springs, only had 12 players. But one of them was hurt.
But what we noticed most about that game is the rodeo arena was next to the football field at Yale High School. And the rodeo arena had bigger stands than the football field.
Huge facility for rodeo. And these little bleachers for the football field.
They had a good crowd, though. I mean, you got
a lot of fun. They all wanted to know what we were doing. All right, now you're down 28. Oh, man.
It's a you're down 24.
24. You know, my man, right up there with yours. And you've got
that was a good one.
First and 10 of the 20.
Yeah. Remind me to keep stats next time.
Next time we're going to have you running camera, keeping stats, providing color. Matt Sox gone all the way at quarterback tonight. He started the game. We haven't seen Patrick Mullins at all. With a lay handoff to Brown, still no Abu Wilson. We haven't seen the first half when he fumbled a couple of times. Could be a little, I don't know that you need, I mean, he's a six-year senior. But
maybe you're gonna, with the game out of hand, you're going to give Brown a chance and give him some experience.
Well, the interesting thing with Sock is you were talking with Coach John L. Smith during the week, and he admitted he was going to play both, and he said the difference there was really foot speed.
Yeah, because the rush that Southern Miss put on Utah State forced him to go to Sock because Mullins, number one, isn't as mobile, and number two, that ankle has been bothering him since the injury in the Utah game. That pass is incomplete, but Sock is much more mobile, and John L. says he's getting better virtually daily. In every practice, he sees improvement in this kid. And to be honest with you, he looks better. A lot of his passes look crisper tonight than they did against the Utah game, which we did at the opener.
Well, he's getting a lot more confidence in the system. He's had a lot more reps. He's had a couple drops tonight. That was a little bit of a tough catch for Smith there, although he could have made it. But
third down and six. Got to keep the drive alive.
We got Sock in the official now, 11 of 22, 159 yards.
We'll give this one to Brown. Brown should have enough room to get the first. Oh, he stopped.
And he wanted to cut that back inside. He might have been better off just making it a foot race to the first down marker over there at the 30.
Yeah, he stopped and cut it back. And now here comes the punt team down 31-7. And the coach was saying, wait a minute.
That's right. Yeah. I don't know if he would have made it if he'd gone for the foot race, but he might have.
Once again, the Aggies are stopped. They have just been stymied tonight. 31-7 with 2.5 to play in this third quarter, and they have to punt again. And their last punt was a doozy.
And they're lining up with their personal protector as if he was going to be the quarterback. Now he drops back, faking the fake. Perfect execution on the knuckleball punt there. They get the great roll down the sideline and no return.
24-yard line is where Oklahoma State will have it. But with the exception of that first drive in this second half, the Cowboys have not had much trouble moving east and west here.
It's a 45-yard punt, no return.
I say east and west because this stadium is not north and south. You ever notice that? Are you listening like on the radio or TV? It's always, and he's running north and south. Not in this stadium. Which is odd. Football stadiums are always seem to be north and south.
The goal lines are to the north and south. Yeah. Right. Here the goal lines are to the east and the west.
I think when they built this stadium, the sun actually rose in the south.
Is that your theory, huh?
Okay. No, but there's 2 minutes to go in the third quarter, and the Aggies are down by 24.
Boy, and I thought our math was bad. Now it turns out our geography isn't so good.
Oh, yeah. Nice little pickup there once again, so give Thompson a few more yards.
He's grinding towards back-to-back 200-yard games. That's 161 yards now, and he got the whole fourth quarter to go. Although you got to wonder, they got so many guys to get carries and get playing time to. They got a big lead. How long do they keep going with him?
Second and two. This might be a down to, you hate to see him throwing the ball at this point of the game, and they won't. So give him some more. First down plus about four.
35 to the 38-yard line. Game six. Nothing fancy, just straight out of the eye. Once again, he cuts and finds the hole. Finishes. Going straight ahead, finishing strong. You know, the interesting thing is they've used a lot of different backs. Nobody's putting the ball on the ground. You got a ball control attack like this, nothing ruins it faster than a turnover. But he's protecting the ball, running between the tackles.
That said one touchdown, and he's counted for two more than that. There's a flag down. I think what you're going to have is a receiver moving on this near side.
Did you see it? I mean, you hate to keep saying, boy, he really has great vision and he cuts, but he was caught in the backfield, stopped, let a tackler fly by who had penetration, beat his man past the line of scrimmage, and then, boom, broke back past him. It was a great move in the backfield.
You hate to keep saying that, but you know what? He really has great vision.
He really does. Watch, here it comes right here. He takes the pitch. He's going to cut. Whoa, and there you go. See you later. Bye-bye.
Nice run, but don't give him that one. It's all coming back. With an offside.
Illegal shift on the offense. A five-yard penalty from the previous spot. Repeat first down.
Thought it was interesting that Coach Smith said that Southern Miss, a team that the Aggies actually had a chance to beat, were very close to, was more athletic than Oklahoma State. That doesn't necessarily mean they're a better team, but certainly a completely different game for the Aggies this week.
Yeah, but Oklahoma State has been better each passing week. And,
yeah,
you see that mostly in the month of September. College teams tend to improve a lot in that part of the season, but especially a team that's this young.
Pitch back once again to Thompson. We'll get a few. Oh, there's a flag. You know, I was wondering if they're going to throw that.
Be a
Ben
late
Croslin hit. Got there a little bit late. Was it Croslin? I don't want to accuse anybody. That.
Actually, I don't think it was.
No, it wasn't.
See, we can see it here.
Might have been Robinson.
Ooh, and with the helmet.
Oh, you know, no. Adam Jones, the defensive end, is the one that got there.
Dead ball, personal foul, defense, 15-yard penalty from the end of the run.
Wow.
And an automatic first down.
Ouch. Personal foul. They've had a couple of those tonight, and they are killers.
That is a first down for the Cowboys. Seven penalties now for 64 yards for Utah State. And meanwhile, 11 penalties for 110 yards on Oklahoma State. So flags have been moving them up and down the field all night.
Reverse, fake reverse. Jones to throw, and he's caught. That's going to be another sack. That should
Croslin.
Be two snacks. Well, you can call it that too for Ben Croslin. Young man from Kemmerer, Wyoming.
How strong are his forearms? He didn't get a full hit there. It looked like he just clutched at him with a hand as he went flying by. Jones trying to sidestep him, and he just got a handful of shirt and with one hand just pulled him down.
That brings us to the close of the third quarter. Aggies trailing 31-7, and the fourth quarter is coming up.
Kimball Roofing, confidence you need in Salt Lake, Ogden, and Provo. Our experts will inspect the roof of your home or business and help you choose the best solution for leaks, weather damage, and aging. Have Kimball Roofing repair existing vents and roofing surfaces or replace your roof with highest quality materials, including durable asphalt shingles, tile, wood, all metal systems, or the latest flat roof membranes. All of our work is guaranteed, and we offer maintenance programs that can double the life of your roof. Protect your lifetime investment with the quality work of Kimball Roofing in Salt Lake, Ogden, and Provo.
For 55 years, we've been with you wherever you go. No matter how far from Utah you've ventured, you've been covered. You don't put limits on where you can go in life. We don't limit your health care choices. For health insurance, the best solutions come out of the blue.
Oh, they're a happy bunch here in Stillwater, and there's nothing like Cowboy football on a Saturday evening in Stillwater. Look at this.
You know, they get Oklahoma in here this year. They beat them last year in Norman. They'd love to take them down two notches 2 years in a row. We do have a final score to pass along. Texas Tech up 12-0 at Georgia. Lost. Georgia came back, won that 15-12. Of course, the Aggies go to Texas Tech next week before they return home to play BYU. And Oklahoma State will see Texas Tech in November here in Stillwater. So Texas Tech losing to Georgia tonight, 15-12 at Georgia.
Incomplete.
Pass is incomplete by Jones. So that'll bring up a third down.
I just said they played Texas Tech in November, didn't I? That would be wrong.
They played
Texas
Stadium.
A&M in November.
There you go.
They lost to Texas Tech a couple weeks ago.
Yeah, in Texas Stadium. That was the one game Texas Tech plays in Texas Stadium. Oh, look at this. Jones is going deep. Uh-oh.
No flag.
They're going to say the ball was not catchable. Wow, Dwayne Nelson covering.
Boy, Jones showing off the arm, though.
But he hasn't had a problem throwing long tonight, has he?
No.
Have not seen Abu Wilson in this second half.
They just showed the replay up on the Jumbotron, Jumbo Vision, whatever they call it here. And the crowd didn't like it any more the second time than they did the first.
It is a Jumbotron, buddy.
Okay. Glad we got that plug in.
Hey, they're punting. How about that? Jason Bandy down at his 10-yard line. And Jason Davis took it away.
And that guy, oh boy, they're getting a great roll.
It'll go to the 13-yard line. That's where the Aggies will take over their first possession here of the fourth quarter. And they need 24 points.
44 yards for Davis.
There's good news for the competition.
I hear Force clearance is in its final days. It's about time.
Factory authorized clearance is almost over, but now you can get $1,500 cash back or 3.9 financing on any 96 Taurus.
$1,500 cash back.
Just announced, $1,500 cash back or 3.9 financing on any 96 Taurus. It all ends October 1st, so see your local Ford dealer today.
The secret's out. Have you heard? Everybody's spreading the word.
The secret's out. The taste of Arby's new chicken, bacon, and Swiss puts ordinary chicken sandwiches to shame. It starts with Arby's marinated and seasoned whole breast filet, our special recipe, so it's extra tender and juicy. Plus our own thick-cut peppered bacon and rich honey mustard.
The secret's out.
You can't beat Arby's new chicken, bacon, and Swiss. Try it and taste why it's better out here.
Here's your Middlecoff Lincoln Mercury third quarter stats. Look at, oh my goodness, Oklahoma State's rushing yardage.
That can't be right. That can't be right.
And you know what? We won't give you credit for that. You've been keeping stats, and those are not yours.
Exactly.
There's no way they have 500 and a gazillion yards of rushing. Nice reception by Chavez down to the 35-yard line is where he's dropped. We'll check those. Right, they have definitely piled up a lot of rushing yards, but not that many. Score is 31-7 at any rate. 14-22 to play here in the ball game. And now the Aggies looking to try to get something going to finish off on a somewhat high note and stay healthy, because there's a couple of guys on the sideline right now that have ice on their knees and their ankles and their legs.
You know, Chavez is one of the guys who's quietly had a nice night. That's three catches for 84 yards for him.
Going deep. Oh, a nice pass, and it is caught at the 30-yard line and finally run down, but not before Nakia Jenkins makes it all the way to the two, and that pass was a rocket. Matt Sock really showing the arm on that one. Take a look at this pass.
Going off the play action fake to Abu Wilson, who's back in the game, and boom, down the sideline, zip it in there. You know, before he tried to do that with a little touch at the end of the half, he got it picked. I didn't see the safety getting there quite as quick. He said, forget the touch, I am zinging this thing in there before anyone gets there.
Well, that puts the Aggies all the way down to the two.
Now, McCorder showed how quick he is, though. That was something closing on Jenkins like that. Making the tackle.
He's back, and he's in.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see down 24 if they go for one or two.
Well,
if they go for two,
they're already sending in the point after, but I would think, just like you're getting ready to say, they should go for two. That puts them within two scores.
Abu, no hole, so he just goes up top, airmail.
Well, if they do this, they'll need three scores.
Well, it's pretty tough to make three consecutive two-point conversions. You tend to make, depending on the team, 35 to 40% of those. So it'd be tough to hit three in a row, which is what it would take to tie it up at 31.
Well, he got that, so the Aggies score in a hurry. That drive didn't take long. And it's now 31 to 14. Utah State, though, needs to get the ball back.
In the Far East, people have long appreciated the need for thoughtfully designed products that make efficient use of limited space. Crosswalk Space Saver, made in America, appreciated around the world.
On the right vehicle. Your patience just paid off. 96 early closeout at Middlecoff Lincoln Mercury. Save up to $4,000 off invoice. Invoices posted on every 96 car and truck. Remember, the invoice price posted is the price Middlecoff paid for the vehicle. The 97s are here and every 96 must go. Save up to $10,000. 96 early closeout only at Middlecoff Lincoln Mercury.
Well, the Aggies showed a little life on that last drive as they score quickly. A nice long pass to Nakia Jenkins, making it 31-14. 13:34 to go. There's the onside kick. It looked like the Aggies had it for a moment there, but Cowboys come up with it. The only hazard in that play, of course, is when you don't get it, the other team has great field position. So now your defense needs to come in, and keep in mind that they didn't get much of a rest because the Aggies scored so quick. But this time of the game, you better score.
They go first down and 10 from the Utah State 44-yard line.
Here's another look. It took a funny hop and pretty much had
it
corralled.
Hang on to it, yep.
Hey, they got a rise out of the crowd here during the last commercial break. Tulsa 27, Iowa 17 in the fourth quarter. Tulsa, of course, not that many miles here from Stillwater to Tulsa, and that's an upset right there.
Well, and they like it because they just beat Tulsa.
Oh, absolutely.
David Thompson, a couple yards on the right side.
And of course, Iowa, a lot of people think they're a contender in the Big Ten. It's also supposed to be a middle of the pack team in the WAC Mountain Division.
Big WAC final there.
Wyoming 22, Air Force 19.
Wyoming's looking good.
And of course, you know Wyoming and Air Force are in the Pacific Division of the WAC.
Which makes a lot of sense.
They're paired up with that San Diego, Fresno, San Jose, and Hawaii quadrant. Well, David Thompson is either done for the night or getting a breather right now.
Kevin Brown with that carry. Actually, Thompson went out to the right side, kind of a decoy. A good pickup there, leaving them with a third down and two. Now another opportunity for the Aggies to try and stop Oklahoma State and get the ball back. Thompson now in the backfield behind Tony Jones. Third down, they need two. Thompson hit behind the line of scrimmage, dropped for a loss, and the Aggies have held them again. And as they jump up out of that pile, get our Chuck-a-rama second look here. And coming out of the defensive secondary, there's Dwayne Nelson,
sending the cornerback.
Kid from Dallas, about 5 hours away from here. So the Cowboys are going to have to kick it away, and the Aggies get another chance here to get the ball. Jason Bandy comes in, and he'll be standing at the 10-yard line. Aggies trailing 31-14, 11:30 to play.
Aggies only have five guys up on the line.
So the Aggies will get it at the 20-yard line, take a couple yards off of that, and it could have been disastrous. But when we come back, Utah State will have the ball at the 20, trailing 31-14.
The Mercury Challenge is on at your Mercury dealer.
Your Lincoln Mercury dealers have been challenged to clear all their 96 models. That means 2,300 Mercuries must be sold before September 30th.
Who knows how much you'll save?
Get great deals on every 96 Mercury. Prices start at just $11,570 for Mercury Tracer after $600 cashback. And there are savings of up to $1,500 on Mercury Villager.
Don't miss the Mercury Challenge at your Mercury dealer now.
See Ken Garf, Bountiful Motors, or Middlecoff Lincoln Mercury today.
Idiots! You have failed me.
Wasn't our fault.
Had a Subaru Outback.
Outback?
Had better gas mileage than our Cherokee.
Held a turn tighter than our Blazer.
Brake better than our Explorer.
Silence, fools. Just tell me what you need to catch him.
Our own Outback would be nice.
With a CD player and leather.
Subaru Outback. The world's first sport utility wagon.
There are the instructions given to the Aggie offense as they get set to take the field, trailing 31-14, 11:20 to play in this game.
Of course, they huddle up on the sideline, so when they come in, Oklahoma State doesn't know who the personnel is. They can't imagine what the formation might be. Trying to get a little element of surprise. Oklahoma State's doing some of the same stuff offensively.
Four wide receivers for Matt Sauk, who's gone the distance tonight. Quick pass right over the middle and some running room. And that will be good for a first down.
Number 14,
Smith.
I think we got a Cowboy down at the end of that play.
And that is the case. Clock will stop. Brandon Ashley, young man from Dallas, Texas. And our Ford power run, let's take a look once again at Steve Smith after he catches the ball.
And remember, this Ford power run by a former quarterback. He was a junior college quarterback and a good one. Now playing receiver. Wow, and I just got attacked. What was that?
They're growing. Big insect came flying.
We don't have a press box window. We have an open space. Watching the replay.
Welcome to the Southwest or Midwest here.
That is the world.
A giant bug just flew in and bit David. At any rate,
that thing had to be cleared for takeoff. That was huge. I'm okay, though. I can take a hit.
Wow.
You know, I actually grew up in Dallas, and you get used to that, but they have these June bugs that are huge. They're like horses.
Sports
fly.
Fans, get into the
they're
game.
Incredible.
On AM 780
Brandon
KMCA,
Ashley.
Monday through Friday, noon
back up on his feet.
Finally, sports talk there really knows what's going
you,
on.
You, what you were trying to say, Cowboys, though, is that Steve Smith played quarterback in years gone by. Again, he's out of that Chaffee College, and John L. Smith, real pipeline from that junior college, because four players on this Aggie team are contributing. It all came out of that college.
But he played quarterback there in high school. He was also a punt and kick returner. I mean, this is a guy who has been able to do pretty much anything.
And Ashley appears to be okay, and the Aggies will resume. Clock begins to run again. We approach 11 minutes to play in this game. Utah State down right now, 31-14, but on the move. Sauk in trouble. Throws downfield and nobody's there. Fortunate he didn't get a sack on that one.
Complete. On the pressure for the Cowboys, number two, Lewis Adams.
You see the mobility of Matt Sauk, and that's he is playing for that very reason, because Patrick Mullins with the injured foot, certainly not as mobile. He's a little bit bigger guy.
Finds an open chunk of ooh, he went down hard on the throwing shoulder, too. He's a little slow getting up, and that explains why. You don't like to see quarterbacks getting dropped like that.
Second down and 10, Abu Wilson now in the backfield. Nice block by Wilson. The pass is caught right at midfield, and that time Steve Smith hauled it in. And you got to credit Abu Wilson. He really leveled one of the oncoming Cowboys that
gave Matt Sock a little time.
We might see it on the right of the screen. No, we didn't, but he saw the blitz. Boy, that ball was zinged in there. That was a very narrow window of opportunity there. But Wilson saw the blitz coming, and if he doesn't get over there and make a good block, Matt Sock is
A pancake.
He's taking a pretty big hit. And he stopped him cold. He didn't let the guy get by him at all. Good block.
Wilson. You know, he's fumbled the ball twice already, and that time he was carrying Louie Adams with him for about 3 yards, just hanging on to the football. Adams is trying to get that ball out of his hands again.
Well, once they knock it to the turf once or twice, they're going to go in there tackling the ball every time.
Clock is moving with close to 10 minutes now to play here in this game. Oh, and he knows it too. Oh, man. He knows he shouldn't have thrown that pass. Now, the question is, if he threw it when he was past the line of scrimmage, does that come back?
No, it'll be an interception. That won't
save
him.
And that's what they are talking about, and they're saying, yes, it's intercepted. Oh, costly. They'll just decline that.
That's the Aggies' first turnover here in the second half. They've taken much better care of the ball after the three in the first half. Now, the interesting thing is one of the things they'd had to work on as a defense was that Utah State had turned the ball over five times, and you like your defense to come out and bail everyone out and make the stop, but it hadn't been doing that. In the first three games, the Aggies turned the ball over five times, and three times it led to touchdowns by the opponent. Tonight, the turnovers had not led to points. The drives have been long drives down the field after a punt. But after the turnovers, the Aggie defense is stiffened. It's one of the things they've done better tonight.
They've only been costly because they stopped the Aggie drive, and that one was looking pretty good. David Gill, by the way, is back into the game. And Thompson, almost wrapped up by Spencer Wagner, gets out of that one. And finally run out of bounds after he gets the first down. Pickup of 13 yards, and Thompson's got to be approaching 200.
Well,
they've gone over.
Once again, a play designed to go right. There is nothing there, and he ends up breaking it back and making a first down on the left sideline. He is a great combination of power and speed. And that is 30 carries for 181 yards unofficially. Because you know I did.
Right, no more unofficial. This time they try the right side again, and Thompson
once again on the carry.
8 yards. I'll give him 9 yards.
Okay,
I will. Give him nine. Go ahead.
So 31 carries for 190 yards.
Gain of about nine.
David Gill will trot back off the field. He's been in and out. He's nursing that sore leg. Second down and one. And this time Thompson has run down, so we're going to take away a yard. Is that Thompson?
Richardson. Andre Richardson.
Andre Richardson gets back into the game. They give Thompson a little breather. Going to bring up a third down and two. Once again, the Aggies, the defense is called upon to try to hold the Cowboys. Clock is moving down now to 9 minutes to play in this game. Left side. Thompson is met at the line. He won't have the first down.
That was third and two and a heck of a play by the Aggie defense. You look at the pile of guys right there. They are all right at the line of scrimmage. And then look at the defensive line. Earlier in the game, they had problems holding the line, and now no one is moved off the line of scrimmage. It's a wall. Every Aggie down lineman holding the spot. Ben Croslin doing good work in there.
Spencer Wagner came up, helped out. He's still trying to unpile it.
Here they spotted. They had to go all the way to the 42. And they're about a yard short. Almost exactly a yard short.
Now, there's no way they need to measure this.
No, the ball is not quite to the 41, and clearly,
not even
the chains are up at the 42.
I mean,
yeah, the Aggies shouldn't complain about the clock being stopped, though. They're on the verge of getting the ball back with 8.5 minutes to go. Need a couple big plays.
Well, it looks like Danilo Robinson is arguing that.
Here come the chains. They're going to measure.
Well, either somebody kicked the yard marker on the far side a yard and a half away, or they're just killing time right now because this shouldn't even be close. And it's not. I mean, look at that. It's more than a yard.
Man.
Very nice.
Rough crowd here. The Cowboy fans are.
Well, even a couple of the Aggies are standing out there raising their hands like, what are we measuring this for?
Now the Cowboy fans are chanting, go, go. I can't imagine. The players are waving at him to chant go, but I can't imagine you would risk giving the Aggies the ball.
No, they're not
on that side of the field.
Mob Simmons is not going to do that.
Paging Barry Switzer. Barry Switzer to the sidelines, please.
Jason Davis will kick it away, and Bandy standing at his 17-yard line. Fields it at the 10. Didn't want it to bounce any further than it did, and manages to bring it up to the 15. So the Aggies will take over exactly 8 minutes to play in this game. They're at the 15-yard line. 31-14 is the score. And they've had a couple of nice drives that have been thwarted. That last one, an interception that you could see Matt Sauk was just ill about. And he brings him out once again. The Aggies got to get moving.
That was a risky play on that punt return there. That's you can get hit just as you're grabbing the ball and turn it over. But since it worked, he did save them probably 10 or 12 yards of field position. They could easily be back up inside the five if he hadn't gone for it there.
Well, I'm not sure who moved first, but on the right side of the Oklahoma State defense, Louis Adams, he was in the backfield before down set.
Well, the Aggies are backing up.
Yeah, well, it looked like the left end for the Aggies
before
may have moved.
Before the snap, false start, offense. 5 yard penalty, still first down.
This has been a long night for that man. A game of a lot of mistakes.
I think the worst part is, even though the score looks lopsided, he looks back at just a couple defensive plays.
Oh.
Ooh.
The Aggies are backing up in a hurry. Abu Wilson with nowhere to go.
And he held the ball, though, and he was going to get it. And
you know, he's very lucky. They've got this spotted at the 6 yard line.
Forward progress to the six.
Yeah.
He takes the handoff at the five. Well, he was at the
six. Yeah, there he is. Yep.
He was at the six. Of course, a couple of Cowboys happened to be there, but he held the ball and took a shot. He had the same problem against Southern Miss last week. A couple of times they came blitzing, shot through the gaps, and it was all he could do to just get there and get the handoff and tuck it away before he took some shots.
Second down and 19. They're showing blitz. Sauk. Pass is complete. Nakia Jenkins still on his feet and crawls ahead for a first down.
And if he could have kept his feet, he is singing that right now. There was a whole lot of turf in front of him. And so he just shook his head right there. He Sauk zips it. There's no one there. No, he just stumbles a little bit, but you can catch your foot in a hurry on the turf, cutting around somebody, and he goes down.
Clock stops long enough to move those chains, but we're at 7 minutes to play now. Matt Sauk to throw. Abu Wilson's got it. And Wilson out of bounds at the 41-yard line.
And the point they are in the game, you really got to start thinking about that. Abu knew it. He got over to the sidelines with a first down. Stop the clock, 6:44. You're down three scores. Get that first down. Get out of bounds. Sauk under pressure, making the right decision. And Wilson's got the first.
31-14. That's your score. 6:44 to play. off again to Wilson, and Wilson doesn't really have much. Maybe to the line of scrimmage.
And there's a late flag, and it's going to be a late hit against the Cowboys.
Yep.
And the Aggies are going to be across midfield.
Personal fouls, those are the killers. Get a big pickup there, assuming that's what it is.
Simmons is going to work the reps here. He knows he's not getting this one back, but he doesn't want to get hit with the next one. But you know what he knows is there's a lot of time left. Weirder things have happened. And we'll see if this is a good call or not. Abu's out of bounds. Two steps out of bounds.
Dead ball. Personal foul. Defense. 15-yard penalty from the end of the run. Automatic first down.
Boy, Abu may have gotten hit, but that's not a hit that's going to hurt anybody.
Well, it puts him at the 45-yard line. Aggies into Oklahoma State side of the football field. 6:38 to go. Sock dumps it to Abu Wilson. And that play was trouble from the get-go. That time he didn't get the blocking that he needed. The blitz was on. That'll keep the clock moving as well.
You see Wilson, no blockers, too many one shorts.
He's giving Sock a chance to throw the ball downfield a little bit. And he's showing what he can do when he gets a little time. And he's got a little time now, dumps this one off, and Abby Wilson can't hang on. That's going to bring up a third down at 12. A little pushing and shoving going on out there. Abu Wilson, the 6'1", 220 senior. He may not look big when you see him on television, but you stand up next to that kid. He is a big guy.
He'll get a look from the NFL next year, no question.
Third and 12. Sock with plenty of time. He's got an open receiver. He goes downfield. And this is caught at the 22-yard line. Nice reception by Steve Smith.
That was a pretty grab. Take a look at this one more time. He's had trouble with a couple of the easy ones early in the game. This one. See if he had possession. We can't see the left foot. The right foot was out. The left foot maybe got
down first. He may have dragged.
Oh, here. Well, better angle here. See if the left foot gets down in bounds. Oh, the left foot is down in bounds first. Yep. That is a good catch and a good call.
Wilson. And Abu gets a couple, but it's been a long, lonely night for him.
Oh, that is one thing Oklahoma State has done a lot better, defending the run. Huge problem for them in the first three games. They've given up more than 500 yards.
I would think there needs to be a little more urgency here at getting the playoff. 5.5 minutes to go. Wilson, by the way, only needed, 67 yards to become the all-time Aggie rusher. I doubt that'll happen tonight.
We'd have to break a couple here. Or one really big one.
Sock. Jenkins kind of got held up a little, and you can do that the first couple of yards. And Sock waited and waited as long as he could and had to throw it.
That was almost a tremendous one-hand catch, though. Even though he didn't make it, you could see.
Third down and 7, what they've got here inside the 20-yard line.
I believe we're in four-down territory, Dave.
Yep.
Although, you need three possessions, you might just take the three here.
That's true.
Blitz, look out.
Oh, man.
He came off the corner untouched.
Wow.
Trent Fisher, the safety, and he's going to come from the top of your screen, untouched. Nobody gets him. There were just too many Cowboys and not enough Aggies. You got to leave the guy who's got the longest path to the quarterback unblocked, and Fisher gets there. He took a good angle. Sock was trying to loop around him and get outside, but he took the right angle and got him.
All right, 47-yard field goal here. As you said, they need three scores anyway. Maybe we'll get the field goal out of the way.
Plus, it's 4th and 18 now. You really have no choice. You got to take the three.
It's long enough again. Got it. There's a big kick for Micah Knorr. So our score is 31-17, 4:21 to go, and you know there is an onside kick coming when we get back.
The excitement of the Nike Utah Classic continues. Announcing a very special sale on the cars driven by the players and officials. Get $1,000 cash off Park Avenue, America's best overall car value. $1,000 cash off the sizzling Regal. Sanctuary, take $1,500 cash off. There's up to $3,000 cash off on all 96 models and spectacular savings on the 97 Tournament LeSabres. Hurry into your Mountain West Buick dealer.
The choice is yours at Chuck-O-Rama. Come on down home to the family place. Bring along your friendly face. Grab a plate or two. It's just like going home. So much to try, nothing's hard to find. So when food's on everybody's mind, head on down, there ain't no need to roam. The choice is yours at Chuck-O-Rama.
Aggies get that field goal, 31-17. They need two more scores, so you know an onside kick is coming now as there is 4:21 to play in this game, and some of the Cowboy faithful beginning to celebrate. But they're not done yet.
Well, what they're going to try and do now as a kicker is you try to kick that ball up high so it takes a series of long little bounces, and then you get that big kick at about 7, 8, 9 yards. Jumps up into some guy's pads, and he's got no chance of catching it. Part art, part science.
Mostly luck.
There's a little bit of that mixed in, no question. That ball isn't around. It's got points on the end. But still, you see kickers practicing. The really good ones
do.
Oklahoma State's got 9 guys up.
There's that
big hop, and it's loose. It's still loose.
Oh, the Aggies were all over it, but they had pretty much all fallen down. Oh.
That was one of the greatest onside kicks you could ever hope to see.
Textbook onside kick.
Oh, you hope you get a big enough hop that it'll hop up and hit somebody in the shoulder pads. If you can get a hop over everybody's head so it becomes a jump ball, now you're golden.
Oh. Matt Wells was right there.
Well, Matt was so close to making the big play. But he got the big, gigantic hop. And when it hops 8 feet in the air, it's just free ball. Anybody can get it.
All right, now it's crucial because you know that the Cowboys will use every second that they can to get a stop. And David Thompson is in the backfield.
By all means, we needed one more flag tonight. This is the 20th penalty if, you know, you don't count the ones that were declined.
Dead ball, encroachment, offense lining up in the neutral zone, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
12 penalties for 115 yards on Oklahoma State tonight.
Boy, what a great onside kick that was.
It's hard to believe an onside kick could be that good, but it really was.
Kickers replay that stuff in their mind over and over.
Thompson wrapped up quickly.
Utah State has all their timeouts to stop the clock, although they're going to have to get the ball back a couple times, so I don't know that John L. Smith wants to spend them right away. But.
And we'll see how long it takes the officials to start the play clock again, and they're taking their time. There we go. So they'll be able to run this thing down to about 3:30.
And Jones is a senior. He ought to know to do that.
Well, he's up to the line. There's still 13 seconds on the play clock. And you would assume he'd use it all now to 10. And he left 8 seconds up there. Oh, Thompson. Nice piece of running.
David Thompson on the carry.
And if I were the Aggies, I would be jumping up in a hurry, get that football down, and clock is still running.
That was a 7-yard gain for Thompson.
He must be approaching.
That is, unofficially, 32 for 197 yards.
Boy, back to back 100 yard gains. You don't get that very often. Close to 3 minutes now. Nine of his last 13 games now, he's over 100 yards, but back to back 200 yard gains, and he can pick up three more. Third and seven. I think they're running left again these days. Boy, they had him wrapped up at one time, and he goes out of bounds with a first down.
That should put him over 200.
And that will put him over 200, according to our official stats. But more importantly, it really puts a blow in the Aggies' efforts to get that football back.
Although you'll notice he does a lot of things right here on this run. The one thing he does do is he's going to run out of bounds at the end of the run. You got that first down. Well, they had a guy tugging on him. He had to get to the first down marker, so he didn't have a lot of choices. He did get the first. Trying to find something you did wrong tonight.
Jeez.
No.
Couple yards on the right side.
You know, one of the many things he does well is he never completely squares up. He never gives a defender a full shot at him. You hit him, but it's always kind of a glancing blow. You never really line him up, get him in your sights, boom, and put a good hit on him.
Now the Aggies are going to take a timeout, and they really have to, down to 2:25, second down and nine coming up. In fact, they may have to spend them both, spend the next one after the next play, if they can hold them. Oklahoma State, a program on the rebound. They had Howard Schnellenberger in Oklahoma a couple years ago. I've seen some of the coaches that have passed through this state, colorful guys.
Yeah, a couple have passed through the stadium.
Yep.
Jimmy Johnson was here in the mid-80s before he went to Miami. Had some 10-win seasons here. Had a couple of okay backs. He recruited some nice guys through here.
Jimmy's always been good with that. Even now in the NFL, he's got
Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
Abdul-Jabbar up there. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, who, by the way, is the younger brother of Sharif Shah, an old friend of ours.
Former Ute,
number 33, the linebacker.
And a former Channel 2 employee, most importantly.
We gave him his start on the sideline.
He's now gone to a lucrative career as an agent, representing his brother.
That's right.
He knows the gravy train when he sees it.
Well, Jimmy's clearly trying to turn Kareem Abdul-Jabbar into another Emmitt Smith down there, and if he keeps that up, then Sharif's going to have a hefty little percentage. Second down and nine, 2:25 to play here. The Aggies trail at 31-17. Now it's Richardson into the game. And he almost gets through to the secondary. He'll pick up a couple. He'll leave him a third and just a little over five. And another timeout. Yeah, I think you've got to here.
So the Aggies will have one left. Clearly, their best-case scenario here is use this last time out here after third down, get the ball, go down and score, onside the kick, go down and score. That is the game plan for the final 15.
There you go. 15. Then get on the plane and head home victorious.
No, actually, you'd probably be going to overtime at that point now.
No, you go for two.
Oh, you would? You're on such a roll?
Oh, absolutely.
Okay, good day.
Yeah, it's such an easy game. We've just figured it all out for you.
Yeah.
Now do it.
The impressive thing is the way when everything was going wrong here, when a couple big plays got away from them, you know, the Aggies hung in there. This could have gotten out of hand. It could have gotten really, really ugly. And I know John L. Smith does not look like he's currently in the mood for silver linings.
Was he smiling?
I think he was. I think there's a little humor on the sideline. Well, he was. He's not anymore.
Followed Dennis Erickson through Washington State, Wyoming,
Idaho.
To Idaho. He's a good coach. You know, the way he's building this Utah State program, and I've said it before, the toughest thing for the Aggies might be keeping him.
It'll be interesting. I can't wait for them in Nevada. They look like the two favorites in the Big West right now, and that's going to be a great game.
Third down and five. The Aggies need to stop right here. The big fullback has the first down, or yes, he does. And that will just about ice it. Evan Brown comes in.
Yeah, they're going to spot it inside the 29. And boy, there's been some great blocking tonight for the Oklahoma State backs. But in this case, he's doing a lot of this on his own. There's a first guy, the straight arm and the shoulder. Take the second hit, take the third hit, and then lean and fall forward. Brown doing a lot of that. Got a good block right at the line of scrimmage. Had a hole there, but then took on three guys to get the first down. See, that's part of, you know, wearing them down. Just so many snaps tonight for Oklahoma State. They've just had the ball and had the ball and had the ball all night long. Now they only need a few more now. Big kid once again going over the right side. Opening up quite a little core running back here. That's Kevin Brown.
Oklahoma State 3-1 now. They got a bye week coming up next week, and then they get to test themselves.
Look at this, a whole new team coming onto the field right now.
And a standing ovation from the crowd as a lot of the starters leave.
Wholesale substitution. Aggies take their last time out, and the youngster, Chris Chalupka, will come in for Tony Jones, who should get a huge ovation from this crowd.
Will the clock operator please reset the clock to a minute 37?
So Oklahoma State gets to test themselves after this win. They're 3-1. They got a bye week next week, and then consecutive road games with Texas and Colorado, a couple nationally ranked schools, and they get them both on the road.
Sounds a little like the Aggies. They get to go to Texas Tech. That doesn't get any easier than this. And then they come home against BYU. BYU's got SMU next week. It'll be very interesting because SMU runs a similar type football game as New Mexico. The quarterback may not be quite as good.
But with Utah State playing Texas Tech next week, remember Texas Tech beat this Oklahoma State team 31-3 in Texas a couple weeks ago. So, but John L. Smith, I remember talking to him in August. We were up there to do a story as they went through their two-a-days. And he was saying, I was talking about the schedule and how tough the first six games were. I mean, they're going to be underdogs in five of them. And John L. Smith said, there's a lot of good teams on this schedule, but he says Texas Tech, they got a chance to be outstanding.
The Aggies will go to 2-2 after this one. People have figured Utah State actually to perhaps be 1-3. Nathan Simmons, the tailback now. I mean, they're getting deep now. He's the coach's son and hasn't been playing, of course, at all yet. They're beyond the two deep.
Well, Bob Simmons was on the ground floor in Colorado when they were busy with one win and 10 losses and took 6-7 years to turn that around and get to where they could contend in the conference, then win the conference, go to a New Year's Day game, finally win the national championship. But he's off to a little quicker start here. Yep. 3-1 in his second year.
Chalupka again is a essentially run out the clock. Probably have to snap it one more time, but that'll pretty much wrap it up. But John L. Smith, get home, get you guys healthy. Have to keep an eye on John Dale Carty, see how he came out.
Well, remember, coming up on 2 News at 10 o'clock, Reece Stein will be along with BYU highlights. BYU and New Mexico, very close game today. Cougars were behind for a while. Had a big touchdown right before the half, you said.
They're now 7-3. They were down 10-7, I believe, and Mealy, about a 70-yard pickup, and then a touchdown right into the corner, so that helped them a lot.
That put them up 10-7. They're down 7-3.
They went up 10-7. And the second half, a fumble was what caused, what created the only touchdown for New Mexico in that second half. By the way, tomorrow in the Den, you mentioned Reese. You know there's snow in them there mountains. Yes, in Utah, and he's up there with some four-wheelers. You're going to see that in Reese's outdoor pieces tomorrow.
We're also going to talk high school football.
Yeah,
a surprising undefeated team, Taylorsville, 4-0. For as near as anyone can tell, first time in school history. Going to take a look at a couple of the reasons they're off to such a good start as the high school season nears the halfway point.
And, of course, some huge NFL. There are three football games tomorrow between undefeated teams that are all division leaders. So a good sports then coming up tomorrow night. At 10:30, Aggies have time for one last snap. There are three Cowboys clear down at the, well, at the goal line, essentially.
They're at the 20, and they're still going.
They're moving up a little. I realize they went a little too far, but this game is basically done. That sock. Over the middle, and it's complete. And that'll wrap it up.
Sean Turner hauls in the final pass of this game, and it's over. And Utah State comes into Big 12 country. John L. Smith on his way over to congratulate Bob Simmons. Two coaches, quality coaches, that are trying to rebuild their programs, but Simmons gets the upper hand today.
Unofficially, we have David Thompson over 200 yards for the night, and with his three touchdowns, he'd be the star of the game. But you know, Utah State, although they were way behind here, I think they go back and look at a couple plays in the second quarter when they had a third and 11, a third and 21, and Tony Jones, the quarterback, once on a quarterback draw and another time, scrambling, ran for first downs, kind of turned this game around, because the Aggies were right with the Cowboys for quite a while and could have stayed with them longer, but for a couple big plays.
Well, Matt Sock gave it his best effort, but the Aggies come up short. Final score from Stillwater, Oklahoma State 31, Utah State 17. We'll be back with a final word after this.
There's good news for the competition.
I hear force clearance is in its final days. It's about time.
Factory authorized clearance is almost over, but now you can get $1,500 cash back or 3.9 financing on any 96 Taurus.
$1,500 cash back.
Just announced, $1,500 cash back or 3.9 financing on any 96 Taurus. It all ends October 1st, so see your local Ford dealer today.
The secret's out. Have you heard? Everybody's spreading the word.
The secret's out. The taste of Arby's new chicken, bacon, and Swiss puts ordinary chicken sandwiches to shame. It starts with Arby's marinated and seasoned whole breast filet, our special recipe, so it's extra tender and juicy. Plus our own thick-cut peppered bacon and rich honey mustard.
The secret's out.
You can't beat Arby's new chicken, bacon, and Swiss. Try it and taste why it's better out here.
Utah State football is brought to you by Middlecoff Lincoln Mercury, by Chuck-O-Rama, by Arby's, by your local Ford dealer, by Icon Health and Fitness, first in fitness, and by Blue Cross and Blue Shield.
Back here in Stillwater, Oklahoma, the Cowboys are victorious over the visiting Utah State Aggies, and boy, it was a clinic on running tonight. Both David Thompson and Tony Jones, the quarterback for Oklahoma State, who really provided a boost, especially on a couple of long third down type plays. And let's take a look at our Middlecoff play of the game, and there were several of them, but twice this young man, number 9, kept drives alive with long third down plays.
And this is when the Aggies are right in the game. It's 14-7 Oklahoma State, third and 21, and Jones, with nobody open, scrambles for 22 yards and a first down. Cowboys go on to score, go up 21-7, score that kind of broke things open.
Our next broadcast will be BYU visiting Utah State. That game will be in Logan on October the 4th. The Cougars victorious today. Next up for the Aggies, they got to play Texas Tech before they come on home to meet the Cougars. Until then, Dave Fox and David James, along with our KUTV sports crew from Stillwater, Oklahoma. So long, and thanks for joining us.
The new Giant Caesar makes everything else look small.
What are you looking at?
The Grand Canyon.
Where?
Right there.
Where?
Right there.
What you eating?
Giant Caesar.
What you stepping in?
Has to be China.
Everything looks small next to the Giant Caesar.
What?
The Giant Caesar. Giant slices with giant pepperoni. $9.99 carried out or have it delivered.
Pizza, pizza.
The Mercury Challenge is on at your Mercury dealer.
Your Lincoln Mercury dealers have been challenged to clear all their 96 models. That means 2,300 Mercuries must be sold before September 30th.
Who knows how much you'll save?
Get great deals on every 96 Mercury. Prices start at just $11,570 for Mercury Tracer after $600 cashback. And there are savings of up to $1,500 on Mercury Villager.
Don't miss the Mercury Challenge at your Mercury dealer now.
See Ken Garf, Bountiful Motors, or Middlecoff Lincoln Mercury today.
Mom says dinner's ready.
No time to eat. I'm finally ready. I've got all the latest Canon equipment. Printer, copier, word processor, my own multifunction scanner, copier, fax. Nothing can stop me now!
Competition's on to me.
Get the guaranteed low price on over 7,000 items and free delivery. Staples, yeah, we've got that.
Robert Redford with sharp words for Utah's congressional delegation.
For my feminine itching, I depend on Vagisil cream to stop it instantly. And for a painful, burning itch, I get maximum strength Vagisil for even stronger relief. There's Vagisil cream and maximum strength.
Hey, honey, I want long skirts and plaid and canvas in blue, blowing tent, insulation, and weather beaters that look new. You'll be the first place. I'll always try, cause just like me, you have a softer side. Come see the softer side of fear.
Next, come Waka, meet your destiny.
Chuck Norris battles to save the life of a golden child.
The boy must be taken alive.
We have no quarrel.
You can have the boy, but first you have to fight me, Jay.
Come on, Walker!
You fought bravely, but now it's over.
The explosive season premiere of Walker, Texas Ranger, CBS Next.
We now join the following program already in progress.
I'm here at the cabin.